138 in progress.
We have a problem.
And my carpet was like dark brown.
Just coolest old lady.
I'd fuck her.
I just don't care.
Hey, can you give me a ride to jail or something?
Now let's get started.
You just can't help it. You just can't help
Boom,
but having to fucking say something over the intro every time.
Yes. I can't help
There's
it.
There's a reason I used to turn down the volume.
Compulsive.
Today I had trust, and I don't know why.
You should never trust me, Alan.
Really?
Actually, I'm a pretty ladies, sweethearts, honeys.
Mary Bird.
Sugar tits.
Sugar tits.
I'm a trustworthy guy.
Boo-boo kitty
I'm a nice
fuck.
Guy. That's a good one.
Boo-boo kitty
Potential Problems Podcast. Hey. Boom.
We're here.
I'm John Cuellar. That is...
Yeah.
Alan Clark.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't think it. We need introductions.
I'm Alan Clark,
anymore.
Everybody. I was on the swim team.
And then I fractured my elbow. I don't know why you're making me sound like I'm from the 50s.
And then John.
You're the one who's 50.
And then John Cuellar beat me in a pool race.
Not even close.
Well, it was photo finish, we'll say. And
you fell behind in my fucking waves.
Well, that was
a cool little race, though. That was quick. You didn't last.
Well,
race.
The one thing I would like to point out is that I train. Well, not even train. I work out. It keeps me sane. Like every other day, every 3 days, something like that. And Alan hasn't swam in how long, Alan?
Well, it's very periodic.
5 years!
What?
He hadn't swam in 5 years, folks.
I haven't trained in 5 years.
Whatever. And he got into that pool, and he was like a fish in beer, folks. He was
fish
like
in
a
beer.
Fish
Wouldn't
in
they just float from all the carbonation?
Possibly. But yeah, that was actually pretty remarkable. And like I said, I take good care of myself, and you kind of haven't worked out very often since you fractured your elbows.
No, I have fallen apart.
So
I have fallen
but
apart.
But you still beat me as the
now
point.
I'm
what
fit.
The fuck?
I'm fit now.
You're fit and you're 50.
I'm fit.
Oh.
Not fit.
It was, let's talk about the, you know what I realized is that a lot of times we don't talk about everyday stuff.
Everyday
stuff.
Like,
we always jump into something.
Oh,
it's always got a boom. We hit the ground running and
jump in.
And then we stall out.
Yeah.
And then we run some more and then we fall.
You know, Don Cherry didn't help on, you know, Wednesday when we tried having our war. And she just totally took all the energy out of it.
Oh, yeah.
But now the Andrew Harm Show has officially responded.
Oh, no.
They are also going to be...
Of course they did, Alan.
Yeah.
They got nothing else
They
going
got
on.
Nothing else. They don't even have good audio. You know...
We have a web show war.
Houston, we have a problem.
Andrew Harm Show, Nick Munoz.
Whatever you're reaching for better be a sandwich because you're going to have to eat it.
I'm gonna make
him an offer,
Gamma.
They'll never take me!
Freedom!
Call you out!
I'm gonna bring the whole fucking diseased, corrupt temple down on your head.
I got something planned for your wife and kid that they ain't never gonna forget.
Either put on these glasses or start eating that trash can.
Webshow War for the Ages!
I'm gonna give you 3 seconds. To wipe that stupid-looking grin off your face, or I will gouge out your eyeballs and skull fuck you!
I only tell you one time. Don't fuck me.
I am 2 seconds from being on you like white on rice and a glass of milk and a paper plate in a snowstorm.
From now on, you better be looking behind you when you walk.
Let the thrashing begin!
Thrashing! Thrashing!
Thrashing! That... Just when I keep listening back to that song and the whole intro, it's just so long-winded. So many of the clips have nothing to do with this. But the Andrew Harm Show has officially responded.
Oh, I bet they do.
Yeah.
What do they got to say?
Representatives of the Potential Problems Podcast have been causing trouble.
Oh.
We've been causing trouble. Yeah. Bringing the peaceful inhabitants of the Andrew Harm Show to mount their armor and load up for full-blown war.
Load.
Giggity. We will not go gently into the night. Hashtag web show war.
That sounds like something Nick wrote.
Yes. And then he shared it immediately after.
I bet he did.
So, This is where we stand right now. Now, they only do one show per week. We do two.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
How long is their show? Like 30...
46.
46 seconds. That's not very long.
No, it's... They might as well just cut it down to a Vine video of Andrew Harms, like, rocking back and forth going...
That would be awesome, though.
Yeah.
Is that even the Andrew Harms show, or is it...
It's the Andrew Harms show hosted...
Okay.
...by Nick.
Why is it hosted by Nick?
I don't know.
What? Why, if it's the Andrew Harms show, why must it be hosted by another?
Why must it?
That's what I'm asking.
That's what I ask when they fuck up my order at a burger place. Why must it? That's when I say it, how I say it when I'm in New York.
You wanted mayo, right?
Yeah. But, yeah, they... I don't know why it's hosted by Nick Munoz, because all he doesn't really host it. It doesn't really seem to have a host. It just sort of, it's a back and forth between him and Andrew, and then they bring the guest into it when they remember that the guest is present.
Oh, okay.
And you know, Nicky Moon is upset. He's already letting us know. And you know, it's...
Oh, what's up, man?
Oh, ooh, who is that?
Yeah, are you in the area?
Who is that? He's working! We're live!
A call-in.
Who is this?
Yeah, let me...
Who is talking?
Here, we'll call you on Skype, okay?
Who is this? I don't trust your kind!
It's not on...
Oh, it's
speaker.
Kevin Baca. Yeah. Hey, Kevin.
Hey, I decided to surprise you guys with a call-in.
What's up? I was almost expecting this to be Nick because he's we're in the middle of a problem with the Andrew Harms show.
Oh, really?
Yeah, it's all out war at this point.
Although I'll point out, Alan's more enthusiastic than I am.
Yeah,
which is not bad.
Wait, who's more enthusiastic? What?
It doesn't matter.
What's up? What's happening right now?
Not much. Just hanging out. You know, doing not much of anything before I gotta go to work.
Oh.
That's why I can never show up, is because I don't have a car, so I can't get all the way up there and do the podcast when we get to work. So I figured, fuck it, I was going to call you guys today.
Well, that's good.
All right. Yeah, let's figure this out on Skype real quick.
Yeah, we'll call you.
Okay, I'll see if I have an ID and call you. What's your ID? Message it.
No, we're going to call you. It'll go through his phone, right?
Wait, do you have a Skype too?
I have a Skype on my phone.
Oh, yeah. That works.
So we can call you right back.
Okay.
Yeah, what's...
Just message John the name, and then I'll look it up.
Okay, I'll try to figure out what it is.
All right. This is very confusing.
We just got
interrupted.
An unexpected call-in by Kevin Baca. Where were you?
They had Jason Green on their third episode.
Okay.
A day after we had Jason Green.
Of course.
I listened to the whole thing. I watched the whole thing. They talk about Star Wars. And if you remember, we talked about Star Wars.
The defense system from the 1980s?
Yes.
Okay.
But then they claim that they don't want to be potential problems' little brother.
Oh, gotcha.
Yeah.
So they're just kind of like retreading what we did.
A little bit. Yeah. A little bit. So, Nick, we're just waiting on a response. We want to see where you guys take it at this point.
Oh, is he following live?
Yeah. He's upset.
He's
upset. And you know, Nick, since you're saying stop talking to Kevin, we're going to keep talking to Kevin. And we're done with this topic. We're waiting on your official video response.
Yeah, we'll check back in with
we'll
it.
Check
let's,
back
let's move it along. Let's move it along.
Yeah.
It was fucking cold this week, man.
Ooh, weather, huh?
Fucking cold, yes.
What are you now, Al Roker, trying to do a 34-hour weather
Al
thong?
Al Roker. It was cold. It was because the temperature really dropped. I think it was like Tuesday night. We were standing outside in Nexus, the open mic. Every Tuesday, folks, open mic, Nexus. Comedy cream pie, as
comedy
my
cream pie.
Partner would say.
As your partner.
Eddie Stevens would tell you plainly that comedy cream pie is the newest name of the open mic producing team for the Tuesday open mics at Nexus. Did I mention it's on Tuesday at 7:30?
Yes. And it's free and blah, blah, blah. Free.
Great beer, great times.
Great responsibility.
Buy a comic a drink, folks. Buy a comic a drink.
Especially us. Or, well, me, I guess.
Yeah, somebody.
Because you don't, yeah. Buy John a root beer.
Yeah, buy me a root beer. Or bring a huge blunt. That would be
object.
Cool.
Hit you over the head.
So it was really cold outside a Tuesday at Nexus. Like, we were hanging out before the show, and it was like t-shirt weather.
It got really cold.
Yes, by like 10 o'clock.
My nipples became a very hard.
Yes.
There's no reason to do an accent for that one. I just felt like it.
And then
I've been working on my accents.
Have you?
I have.
In print or just in speech?
In speech.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So not that many names really call for
my writing is still
days.
Very misleading. There's no accents in the right places, and you don't know where a sentence ends. It's like one big comma of a paragraph.
Is that what it is?
That's what it is.
And then by 10 o'clock at night outside of Breck a Bird, it was...
Breck a Bird that I shoot from the sky.
it was fucking cold out there, man. It was cold. Mary, you know what
I was back at home. I was back at home and warm. And
Alan was home, warm, using his fleshlight, his zombie fleshlight.
Zombie.
What do you folks think of the zombie fleshlight? Any fans out there of the zombie fleshlight?
Nick, we know... Nick. He probably wedges it into a toilet seat somehow.
Zombie fleshlight. That's creepy. So it was really cold. And then it was, look outside.
I think the
today.
Zombie fleshlight is okay for like people who are worried about being necrophiliacs.
Worried about it.
Yeah. Like, because you don't want to actually, like.
Well, is that against the law in New Mexico?
Yes, it is.
In New Mexico.
You know, I'm not sure.
That's pretty.
Let me look this up. If I would assume it's illegal.
I would assume. It should be. And it's one of those things like, why isn't it?
Is necrophiliac illegal in... No, but what is? What the
L.
fuck? Is necrophilia legal in New Mexico? You gotta like technology.
Yeah.
Is necro... Oh, okay, here's an interesting... Oh, God. Oh, God.
What is
oh,
it?
Oh, no. First, like, I saw the preview, it said godless heathens.
Godless heathens.
And then New Mexico was highlighted. Wow.
Sounds
okay.
Like a metal band.
Okay, it looks like it's legal in Kansas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, and North Carolina? South Carolina. Yeah.
Huh.
Yeah. So over there, I guess you don't really need zombie fleshlights. But in other states, if you're worried about it...
A zombie fleshlight is required.
Yeah.
If that's what you're into.
Yeah, exactly. If you don't want to get caught.
Some people didn't even know that there were zombie fleshlights out there.
No?
No. Speaking of zombie fleshlights, you guys remember that movie Ghostbusters?
Ghostbusters.
Where...
I like to kill a ghost. They haunt my family. Very dishonorable.
Very dishonorable ghosts, huh?
I tried to stab them with my sword, but they go right through. And then I get strapped.
That part. Have you seen Ghostbusters, Alan?
I've seen them. I'm not going to see the all-woman one.
You're not?
No, because they're wanting to do that. I say no way.
Well, I was staunchly against... I'm like, why do you have to flip it like that? But then I heard Tina Fey was going to be in it. And if that's the truth,
still,
fuck yeah.
She's not
going
to bring
board.
Any quirky, sexy energy
she
to
is.
Ghostbusters
she's
unless she
like,
plays Sigourney Weaver's role.
She would be, well, maybe that's
she
what
has to play
do.
Sigourney Weaver's role.
Maybe that's what they'll do.
What if they have her play, like in the credits, you see Tina Fey, Sigourney Weaver, as whatever her name was. What was her name?
Ray Winston?
I mean, sure that's what Sigourney Weaver's character's name was.
Oh, Ripley.
Ripley.
From Aliens,
God damn
right?
it, no.
From Aliens?
Believe it or not, it's not. See, Ripley's Believe It or Not. Did you ever watch that?
Oh, yes,
but
yes.
Anyways, Ghostbuster chick name.
Ripley's, I don't give a shit.
Yeah.
Her Ghostbuster broad name.
Yes, her Ghostbuster broad name.
She was, what was her name? Anybody out there on the internet? What was Sigourney Weaver's character's name?
Why are you deleting comments?
I haven't deleted shit.
There used to be comments. Someone's deleting comments. I don't know what's going on.
I don't know what's going on.
Anyway, Sigourney Weaver's character should be labeled as Tina Fey.
She was the gatekeeper. And there was the keymaster, which is Rick Moranis.
Rick Moranis.
Yes.
I remember the Tourette's guy videos. He used to have a problem with Rick Moranis.
Really?
Yeah. He was like yelling at his son. He goes, "Who the fuck is Rick Moranis?"
Wait, who's this guy?
Tourette's guy.
Who's Tourette's guy?
You never saw Tourette's guy.
I never saw Tourette's guy.
Holy shit. Tourette's guy was one of the best internet things that happened around 2007 or so.
Oh, shit. So you were like 14?
Yeah, I was in middle school when I found out about Tourette's guy.
Tourette's. Her name was Dana.
Dana, that's right.
Dana.
That's right. Dana. Let's see, so here's Tourette's guy.
It's all right. It's pretty good. Who's a faggot with tuba?
That's our dad!
Watch your mouth!
Oh, shit! Sorry!
Dad, there's nothing to eat for breakfast.
Some cereal right here.
Tourette's guy.
Oh, that's total. I don't really like that.
Don't talk shit about Total!
It's just so unnecessary.
Yeah, I heard he killed himself.
The United States Air Force going for 10...
I killed myself too, but my last name was... Calm!
Oh, Bob Saget! Oh, Bob Saget!
There's a bunch of bees.
Oh, shit!
Are those bees or his
Bob
Tourette's?
Saget! Oh,
well, he's getting bitten by bees, which is why he runs inside.
Oh, okay.
And his Tourette's is partly the alcohol, of course, because he's always drinking.
Bitch!
Ah! Oh, shit! Where's my fucking glasses? Where's the paper towel?
Fucking Tourette's guy is the shit.
Fall over here! Ouch! Motherfucker, give me the dick!
Sorry.
You're lucky one to hurt! I mean, this thing, not my dick!
Yeah, that was Tourette's guy. I was way into that in middle school. But then he apparently died.
He died?
And there was all this
stuff.
Wait,
the guy in these videos died?
Yeah, the blue guy.
He needed the money.
And he always wore a Tony the Tiger shirt.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but apparently the story was he died.
Apparently
then,
his health wasn't great. Oh, I almost said terrific. And
good.
I said great.
Good. I'm glad you fucked that one up. But because, oh my God, you were just stringing together a line of bombing jokes last night that wouldn't fucking end.
I was really high, Alan. High on Jesus.
Apparently rapping for Jesus.
Rapping for Jesus.
There was a bunch of people saying that that the Tourette's guy wasn't real, and being in middle school, you want to believe it's like Santa Claus.
Santa Claus, yeah.
That's funny because I heard Jim Norton saying it like that when he was interviewing Mick Foley about a Santa movie. And then the other day, me and Uriah, we were at the mall picking up his glasses. And
Kevin Baca says to just look up his name.
Okay.
Anyway, go ahead.
So, we were at the mall, and I saw the Santa display, and there was a dude as Santa there. So,
was he dressed in his Santa gear?
Not completely. He had a big blue shirt on. He needed the money.
Did he have the red pants?
Yeah, he had the red pants on. And he was sitting down in the chair and everything, and I'm walking by. I was like, "Hi, Santa." And he actually went, like, replied back. He's like,
"Wave."
Yeah, he was like, "It's actually Santa." Like, I don't know. It's like, yeah, that's what
say?
I said, Santa. I don't know why it's just so funny to drop it like that in just conversation when you're talking about Santa.
I just sent a vulgar text message to Will Bolt.
Why? What happened?
I don't know. Just because he was being a nice guy, and then I was being a nice guy, and then I decided to send him something horrible, just because, you know. It's, we got to keep it real. Keep it real.
Can't figure out which Kevin Baca is Kevin Baca.
Kevin Baca. There's
no picture.
There's. How would we distinguish you, Kevin Baca?
One of them just says United States. One of them. Yeah, it says. Jesus. There's apparently a lot of Kevin Bacas. Ooh, I wonder if it's the one in Tegucigalpa? I don't know if that's a place. Oh, wait, here we go. Is that... No, that's not Kevin. Where is it? I don't know. I'm about to give up. Just tell him... Here, let me...
Hey, do a phoner.
No. Anyways.
What were we talking about? Oh, Ghostbusters. That all started from Ghostbusters. Ghostbusters. But... do you remember that scene where Dan Aykroyd is laying on his bed and that ghost rapes him? That, like, you see his belt come off.
Oh, and, like, yeah, that's right.
And then, like, they imply that the ghost goes down on him and gives him ghost head.
It gave him ghost head?
I think it did.
I don't know how to send the message. Oh, there it goes.
And then he woke up and they're like, oh, look, I think you got slimed by a ghost. And he was like, I sure did. But that part of the movie always seems out of place. And there's a few sexual things about Ghostbuster.
A few.
About, like, Ghostbusters.
Like the baby in the second one.
Well,
Dana was a whore. She had a baby.
From some guy in the symphony, right? In the first
flutist.
One. Okay, so in the first one, you have the ghost rapey blowjob.
Yeah.
That's kind of creepy.
Yeah.
You have,
I've had a few of those dreams.
The keymaster and the gatekeeper. So you have Rick Moranis just totally boning
the shit
out of... There
was a sexual tension between them.
Yeah, well, do you remember that it's heavily implied that he sticks his gate in her... I mean, his key in her gate? And
it's very heavily implied, yes. But
and no, that's
what I liked about those movies, is I never really went right out and said it.
I hated that about those movies.
Really?
No, I don't know. I just said that to be contrary.
Oh, that's not very funny.
It wasn't supposed to be funny. Moving the conversation along here, but there was that, and then you've heard that song Ghostbusters, right? Who you gonna call? Ghostbusters, yeah, with Ray Parker Jr., who eventually had to give away most of his earnings, I think almost all of them.
Good!
To Huey Lewis, because they found that song was very similar to I Want a New Drug.
Really?
Huey Lewis, yeah, so...
I didn't know that.
The courts
still
made
gets...
him hand over almost all the cash from
Is that why it's pretty much public domain now and almost anybody can use it without really...
I don't,
because I noticed it's on a bunch of, like, Halloween CDs, and that seems to be one of the go-tos when you can't really use huge licensed music.
Yeah.
Because you would assume if Huey Lewis sued them over, like, it being too similar, that would also revoke their right to make profit from it. Unless they just give away royalties.
I think what they wanted was the profit from it. That's what they ended up getting.
But
I don't know what happens to the copyright after that. I would assume the original artist retains ownership, but what the fuck do I know?
Yeah, yeah.
But there's that part in the Ghostbusters song where Ray Parker Jr. very sneakily, very, very, in a very subtle fashion, he injects the phrase, "Bustin' makes me feel good."
Yeah.
And
yeah,
it's one of those things where obviously he sings it a lot better, folks.
Must it makes me feel good.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.
And that was just one of those things, again, you don't notice until you're a little bit older. Like the ghost blowjob, the gatekeeper, the bustin' makes me feel good, all that shit. It's kind of I'm wondering how far they'll push the envelope,
all the way to the
say,
mail, I say.
Possibly.
Like it has to get out in, you know, good time, so
yeah, how
check doesn't bounce.
Raunchy and how much are they going to toe the line like the original Ghostbusters did? You know what I mean?
As far as, like, innuendos and stuff like that.
Innuendos, ghost blowjobs. Like, is Tina Fey going to open her legs and all of a sudden some ghost is going to go down on her? I think that would probably...
That's an implication that she had a miscarriage.
I think...
Ghostbusters is trying to be edgy.
Well, I think that would just, that would not go over as well as a man getting a ghost blowjob, right? Right? A ghost going down on Tina Fey, like, in while she's sleeping.
Well, I don't, it happened in Scary Movie too. Remember, there was that one girl who was in her room, but
then she ended up raping the ghost, right?
No, she ended up participating after the ghost stuck its dick in her mouth, and you could see it coming out of the back of her neck, the lump.
Don't you
remember that visual scene?
Yeah. Don't you remember how, as Alan gets up to let Kyle in, don't you remember how the ghost becomes less enthusiastic as the what's up, Kyle?
The ghost really did become unenthusiastic about it.
Well, and then at some point, doesn't she like drag him back into bed with her or something like that? Or
I can't recall. It's been a while since I've seen
Ghostbusters. Anyway, that's all bullshit. We're going over Ghostbusters. Have you heard about the new Ghostbusters they're making, Kyle?
Oh, is that still like a go?
I think so. Have you heard otherwise? My agent hasn't called me, so I don't know what's going on with it.
Yeah, I didn't get to call you, so I assume they just scrapped the whole
thing.
Yeah,
me too. I assume.
Well, it's all female is the problem.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Did you hear about that? It's going to be all female.
Female? Email what?
All female Ghostbusters.
That's the word.
Really?
Yeah, that's what's happening.
No. And I still didn't get a call.
No, there you go.
I don't look similar enough.
What's going on, man? How you doing?
Good, dude. Had a in the middle of a soccer tournament this weekend.
Oh, really?
Yeah, we're going to try to win this fucker.
That's cool. What time were your games?
I had an early one at 10:30, and then another one is going to be at 5:30. So I got enough time to.
Wow. Well, we're honored you decided to stop by here, and that's cool, man.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
You can get all fucked up before you go to the second game? No.
Energy drink. I
get Red Balls, baby.
Do you remember they Red Bull offered people like $5 if they bought a Red Bull in the last few years and it didn't give them wings? That was the thing. Like, they actually had like a lawsuit thing going on because Red Bull doesn't give people wings. And you're able, if you've bought it and have proof in the last 5 years, like a receipt, you give it to them and they give you $5.
Right.
But that's awesome.
Why would people think it actually gave you wings?
Because people are dumb.
But why would Red Bull not put a disclaimer and, like, you know what I mean? Just
Will
assume they were going to get sued for that shit. Like, hey, just so you know.
You got to be careful with your marketing.
It's a euphemism or something.
Yeah, you got to be careful with the marketing techniques. That's all there is to that.
How's Adieu going? How'd it go the other night?
Yeah.
It's good. We're getting it's nice to have more crowd than comics.
Oh yeah, definitely.
So that's cool.
Hey, that's at any show you'd want to have.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of that.
Get the
bitch.
Fucking dog
down.
Yeah, so
going good.
It was a good show this last Thursday.
That's every Thursday, Ed. What is it
every
actually
Thursday,
called?
Thursday. Yeah. Doing it well at a Dew Cafe. 8 to 10.
What time do you actually get there for sign up?
I show up at 7, and I always tell people that we're 8 to 10. We never get started before 8:15 ever. Okay. And, you know, depending on how many people show up, how much time we give. It's lately, it's been about 10 minutes, everybody. So if you want, I'll give you 10 fucking whole minutes.
Oh, shit.
Okay. Nice. I'll have to actually make it there one night.
Yeah, definitely.
That would be cool. I would love to be graced with your presence there, Mr.
No, Clark. I just mean for like the 10-minute slot. I've never done 10 minutes before.
Oh, it has nothing to do with supporting.
I know.
Shit. Or
yeah, it's just a matter of.
You're not with me. That's cool.
Yeah.
No, I just want the 10 minutes. Go fist yourself.
Yeah. Man. I want nothing to do with it. That's, yeah. No, we're good. We're good.
I wish I brought my wife, Peter.
You could.
That happened.
I didn't know we were going to be on.
That happened when Royal was on. Him and John were both wearing a black wife beater, sitting next to each other. They looked gay.
We did look like a gay couple.
Yeah, and
pretty,
clearly you would be
awesome.
The bottom.
You think so?
Yeah.
Oh no, fuck no, my friend.
You don't think Royal wouldn't like have to be a top?
No, Royal strikes me as a power bottom.
Yes, he is a power bottom, definitely. Royal would be a power bottom. He would be fucking back.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
All right, I don't.
He's,
yeah,
he's got a masculine and a feminine energy.
Punch
he's got
me
both.
In the face.
Right? He's a beautiful man.
Would that be man pretty?
Yeah, he's man pretty, right? I could see. I see him pulling his share of broads. You know, he's pretty good. What did you have there on the old your very?
We didn't get to
post-it?
A lot of shit. We didn't get to a lot of things last time.
There were a lot of things last time.
I thought it was funny on Wednesday how like our legitimate guest came in like not a comedian.
Does that make me an illegitimate guest?
No, it makes you a comedian guest. Oh. But we had a guy who owns a security company come in to talk, and first thing that Don Cherry started talking to him about was like father-daughter porn or whatever. And she's like, hey, we could actually probably do that. You look just old enough. It's like, wow. That's an interesting sort of thing to walk in on.
That's a good take on that.
What do you know about incest porn, Kyle?
Not a lot at all.
Okay, good.
You know, there's a lot of things that are in my wheelhouse. That's just not one of them.
According to what we learned, if it's free, it's probably acting. If you don't have to pay for the incest porn, it's probably acting.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That's apparently the rule, I was told.
That's disgusting. I can't even think of anything funny or like a joke to make about that.
Yeah,
shit.
I know.
Like, I'm just... Huh.
And Nick Munoz was convinced the other way.
Yeah. You know what's funny about porn is you find, at least the websites I go to, there's a lot of thumbnails. And when you look at one video, it'll bring up associated videos, or sometimes it'll just throw something out of left field
at you.
You
get stuck in a loop.
And you're like, wait a second. And it really is like anything else on the internet. You follow it long enough and it gets pretty fucking dark.
Go down that rabbit hole, man.
Yeah. I found like there have been some videos that I've seen. It's like not even bondage porn. It's like almost like torture porn.
Did you hack my phone again?
Is that why it was in my history?
And sometimes you look at that just for a second, just to see. You know, you get curious. You're like, oh, what is this?
Like, what's the big hoopla?
Yeah, why is this girl hogtied and there's a mechanical or a motorized car with a dildo mounted on it. Like, what is the...
What's gonna... piston.
As a piston.
Yeah. Is that a Sawzall with a 12-inch black cock?
Exactly.
Isn't that what Jason Green was calling a fuck saw?
Yes.
I want to see one like with the pull start going...
A gasoline-powered fuck saw. Texas fuck saw massacre.
If it's electric, you can only fuck so far out of your radius before you got to get a longer extension cord.
Yeah, yeah, Debbie went to go do Dallas and became a victim of the Texas fuck saw massacre.
There's definitely a crossover porno right there.
Yeah, she couldn't walk for days.
There's there are those humiliation ones. Have you seen those ones? I know, it's pretty dark. Stick with me, folks.
I know. Yeah, I know what you mean.
I would just...
This isn't darker than zombie fleshlights that we were just talking about.
Oh, yeah,
about.
We were what do you think of the zombie fleshlight? Kyle, would you ever use one?
I don't know what that is.
You don't know what a zombie fleshlight is?
A fleshlight is a thing that you stick your dick in, and it's like a molded pussy or whatever. And it was funny, the Doug Benson joke from that special we were watching, Doug Dynasty. He was like, I wanted to come up with a slogan, but they wouldn't accept it. I was like, fleshlight. Fuck those things.
Yeah, that's a good one. Now, whenever you say a zombie fleshlight, is it
zombie?
Is the fleshlight like, am I fucking a zombie puss, or is it a fleshlight for zombies to fuck?
It's a zombie pussy.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. So
well, I mean, you know, I don't know.
Well, that's a very
probably got to be a zombie that's you know, wants to bang. That doesn't look like a zombie. That looks like half the chicks I fuck.
Oh, yeah.
Lesions and fucking...
Oh, is that it?
Yeah. The viewers are going to get a very, very, very quick view. Very quick view.
Was there a zombie cock before that I saw? Because that might be fun.
Yeah, they have those as well. That's...
Show me the zombie. Who wouldn't put that puss away. I want to see the zombie.
Oh, no.
That's hot teeth. Holy fuck, is that teeth?
Oh.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, that's a sewn together mouth. A sewn together mouth.
No. That's pretty cool.
That's bizarre.
But
though.
How do you fuck it?
It's how could you not?
Through the stitches? I don't know. That's the worrisome part.
What's the red one down there? All right, hey, we got to stop this. We're about to go
seriously.
Do some real
we are about
shit.
To. Like,
we were just talking about
bondage in no time.
We were just talking about the rabbit hole. And apparently the zombie fleshlight can fit in a rabbit hole.
Oh, man.
So there are these humiliation videos where it'll be like the guy will grab the chick roughly, and then he'll and keep in mind this is not what I watch to get off, but it's what I watch.
It's the rabbit
out of curiosity. Yes,
it's what I watch and, when I'm done getting off.
Yeah, where you're just like, why?
Where you just want to get some pre going, some post. You want to get your post going into the pre.
It's just a, you guys know what that's cycle.
Like. Have you ever had a girl that just loved to suck the post and the pre, and then it just was a vicious cycle until your dick was just like
no.
This? Oh,
have you ever had a chick that just loved to fuck all the time but was terrible at it?
Yes.
What the like? That blows my mind. Like, if you're gonna want to fuck me constantly,
see,
like,
the problem is they want to get
be
fucked.
Good at it.
They want to get fucked all.
No,
the time.
That's the problem. Well, in my
they don't
want to
pitch
least.
In.
No, because I like to.
Yeah.
Pound a pussy, and that's
get
the problem.
Into it.
They don't. They're just like, no, you can't treat me that way. I'm okay.
You can't
shut up.
You can't treat me that way.
That's an exact quote, actually.
Yep. Yeah.
Like during.
Except it was
let's
more
all
like,
let's all go over some exact quotes. Let's all go over some exact quotes.
Exact quotes. What's an exact quote you got there, Alan?
From stop a, pushing my head.
Really?
Yeah, that was one.
That's good.
Or else I'll bite. And that was not fun. That was the second part of that one.
How far back was this?
I was in 12th grade, so it's a few years ago. Yeah.
Okay. Kyle?
One more time for free?
Really?
I don't even think I need to go into the explanation on that one.
She was clearly a trooper.
Clearly, yeah.
She racket to make a rise.
Except like more like moch, you know?
More moch.
Yeah.
What is moch?
Apparently this is like a Belen word that I've never moch. Nobody ever knows what I'm talking about. Moch is whenever you talk like super bean, like, ee, that's all sick, eh? That's
oh,
with
yeah.
The moch homes.
Ee. I hate that shit.
Direct
all sick.
Direct quote from a broad I banged. Did you fart? She
did you?
Actually. Yes, I did.
Okay.
And then I
thank
giggled
God.
About it. I was like, and I kept going.
It's just like, no, that's,
give her a response.
That's how my cum smells, baby.
What the
I
fuck?
I fucking hate fruit.
That's how I bet you can't wait to taste it.
Why would there be methane and sulfur flavors?
You don't know my life.
I was eating fireworks.
I was eating fireworks.
So I've been writing down stories as I remember them, just in case, you know, you guys ever
ooh,
had me
what
back
kind
on.
Of stories?
Just different shit from my life, if you guys, you know, have any, whoa. If you don't want to pick any of that out or anything.
Why don't you pick something out?
Wow, because they're all so good. I got what I mean.
Oh, let me see. You barely got a gun there. Pulled on you in sixth grade.
Barely.
Yeah, that happened to me in fifth grade. In front of a Dion's just up the street on Academy. That was fun.
Right here, yeah.
Yeah.
Was it by another fifth grader?
No, it was by an eighth grader. So they're like infinitely more powerful.
That's why you fuck
at that age, they're infinitely more powerful.
You can't be fucking around with older kids.
So we called the cops on them later that night.
Okay, here we go. Gangbang in my bathroom apartment.
Oh,
behind
yeah,
Pizza
let's get
Hut.
Into that.
Yeah. So, like how? I said, I'm from Belen.
Okay.
This was probably 6-7 years ago. One of my good buddies that I grew up with, we got an apartment just so hood and ghetto.
Where at?
In Belen,
okay.
Behind the Pizza Hut.
Behind the Pizza Hut.
If you guys are from Belen, you know exactly what the fuck I'm talking about.
Nice.
It's in between the Pizza Hut and Tabit Lumber there.
Okay.
You know.
Yeah, right there.
So it was very, very hood, and I don't know what happened. Like, my buddy all of a sudden decided, like, one year that he just wanted to be ghetto. Like, just hang out with really hood motherfuckers and, like, just do a lot of meth and just wanted to be ghetto. It was weird. I'm glad he grew out of that by now.
Yeah.
But I got home from work one day, and a bunch of these ghetto fuckers that he liked were still in high school.
Yeah.
Which was a little weird because we were about 3 or 4 years removed.
Okay.
By then, like, we had just got out of high school. Like, but the kids that he were hanging out with in high school were not in high school while we were there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about.
But those chicks are usually so hot. Anyway, keep going.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
When you're that age and it's okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Sure.
Now.
Sure.
What are you saying, man? Anyhow, I get home from work one day and the setup on our apartment was directly when I opened the front door, the first thing I can see in my line of vision is the bathroom. And that door was wide open, and there was these four little high school boys just banging the shit out of this one little high school girl right there.
Oh, shit.
And
wait,
homie,
when you say four of them banging one chick.
You mean four guys?
Were they taking
turns?
They're
running
turns,
a train.
Or were they, was she like taking care of two guys at once?
Or was she acting like a drummer and using every limb?
There was one guy that was filming. One guy was getting Jade off. One guy was, I couldn't tell if it was just the pooper or backside, you know, doggy style. And one was getting the mouth.
Gotcha.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Was it
that
safe?
That is a busy girl.
Was there no rapping?
There was nothing rapped. Like, it was just them and the good lords, you know.
Fluids.
I was going to say lubes, natural lubes.
Yeah. And how...
And homeboy, my roommate is
wait
just
a second,
sitting
wait a
on
before
the couch
we go,
playing
is
video
she,
games.
Is she hot?
God dang it. She was, man.
So that's
it was just ruined for me. And I was like, God, what is wrong with you? I could have just torn that up for you, darling. Like, by myself.
But now you're
and
ruined.
I would have done it in a bed. You wouldn't have to sit on a toilet for this.
Is she was getting it on the toilet?
It was in the fucking bathroom. Like, she was leaned over, like, her fucking one hand that wasn't jerking off was on the tank. Yeah, it was.
And your friend was playing video games in the living room?
Yeah, and I'm glad that you asked me about this story, because this just kind of made me think of another story that happened in the same apartment. Uh-huh. Like I said, when I opened the door, I don't know why I didn't, like, knock on my own house after a few of these fucking
did it bother
instances.
You? Like, did you worry? You wanted to watch?
Yeah,
did you watch?
No, I was like, dude, like,
standing
this
in the corner
is,
silently.
This is like beyond illegal right
just
now. Like,
fapping.
This shit can't be happening.
Oh, that's
in
why,
my
because
house.
She was like, under 18.
Yeah, and like,
and
I'm
you guys
like,
were over 21, probably.
Well, yeah, I was 21, 22 at the time.
Yeah,
so, like, definitely in the fucked. Illegal range. Yeah, and she was probably like a sophomore or something.
Oh, God.
Yeah. And I was just, yeah, like, I didn't like that he hung out with that he had high school kids at my house at all
yeah.
to begin with, let alone. Fuck
that! That shit was
the
yeah,
train bang of
some
just,
huge fucking problems there.
So another day, I can't remember if this was before or after the gangbang, but I walk home and I keep. I hope I don't remember if I said the guy's name yet or not. I hope I haven't.
No, you haven't.
Okay. Well, in that case, his name is no. Anyhow, I've known this guy since fourth grade. One day, I walk home and, like I said, you open the door, direct line of sight, bathroom. If somebody would use the bathroom door, we could have saved a lot of heartache on this. But I open the door, and he's standing in front of the mirror, flexing like this, with his shirt pulled up above his chest and his shorts down to his knees. And he's just flexing, looking at his dick in the mirror. like with a fucking erection. He's just, ugh. I was like, Jesus Christ, man.
What are you
like,
doing?
Did he turn around? He heard you?
Dog, what? Like, he's pissed at me.
Dog, what the fuck?
Come on, dog. Oh, man. Yep. So that was...
with the steamy heart on,
God,
just turning over.
Like, you can tell that these apartments were built for unsavory
fucking
people.
Off.
No, well, that too. I mean, they're what I like to call domestic violence walls. You know what I mean? Like,
you can hear
you
all the domestic violence.
Well, and you can't punch through them because, you know what I mean? As a maintenance on an apartment complex that's got such rowdy, ghetto, rough people there, you can't afford to be spackling and fixing holes every weekend in these people whenever they beat their kids and wives around. So you got to have like a solid adobe wall that, like, you know, even if you give it the old 1-2, maybe a small
you're hurting
bench.
Yourself.
Yeah.
Are we non-visual right now?
No, it's working.
Okay, just curious.
Your phone just sucks.
Okay. No, yeah, it's not. Yeah. It's because I didn't see it up there.
Oh.
I was just curious. Oh. That's all. It doesn't matter.
Stop being paranoid, man.
I'm not paranoid.
Oh, I was going to say stop being a voyeur. Are we visual?
Yeah, I like
that. I like to watch.
Would you?
I would watch a gangbang. Why not? I wouldn't pay to watch
it. No, I wouldn't watch a train. Because that's what that was from what it sounds like.
That's a gangbang.
No,
it's
not
a gang. I would just pay to be a part of a train.
Oh. Anyways,
I missed it.
let's see here. You've got some other good stories. Let me pick another one here.
But like you were saying, the apartment maintenance just doesn't, or like for that kind of thing, they don't really give a shit. But the other day, I fucking walked into the main entrance, like from this parking lot over here, and I look at where they just remounted the doors onto the frames and stuff. There were screws sticking out of the frame about that far.
Like, different size screws went all the way through this paneling and through, and they're sticking out a good inch.
Just exposed?
Yeah.
It's like an obstacle course, you know what
let
I mean?
Let me get the picture.
Defense measures.
It's like, fucking really? You guys can't use normal size fucking screws to mount a door? Look at this shit. Here's a picture. Look at that! Look at that!
Oh. I think we can just have some put that to the video, man. That's
yeah.
Let the world see that. That is,
where is that?
Wild. That's here? The front door.
Jesus,
for the stairwell. It's just sticking. That's the window going into the stairwell.
Did they just lop them off after?
No.
A while, is it still like that? You should send that to the news or some
dude,
shit.
Dude, okay.
Know. Bob Barker,
you know what?
Would flip his lid on that.
Larry Barker and
Larry
Barker.
He'll loosen his tie, take off his suit jacket.
Same difference.
But, dude, I had a leak coming out of the handle of my shower. There was water coming out of the handle.
Is that what you call your dick?
Sure! But there was water coming out of the handle. I call for them to fix it, because since it's a leak, it's usually a high priority.
Yeah.
A week later, they came by. A week. You had a leak in your bathroom faucet on your shower? I did.
It's a week for a leak.
Did you go and fix it?
No, it stopped.
It just stopped.
It just stopped.
See, that's how I like to view my body. Like, when something goes wrong, like if I have an ailment or something, if it doesn't just correct itself after a week, then I consider a doctor or something. You know,
that's when you,
you know. But like, fuck it. Like, I'll let that shit ride.
What's this Belen party shitting I hear about?
See,
shitting and parties go together in a very awkward way. There's sometimes one person or many people that end up shitting in the course of a party or during the course of the party, and it's always hilarious and awkward.
How's and ifs?
What happened, man?
Well, in Belen, it's different from a lot of kids that grew up in actual like cities or something, you know. I imagine in Albuquerque in high school, most of the time you have parties there at a house party. You might have like one or two outside parties a year.
Yeah,
we were like the opposite. Like, we were all outside parties with bonfires and pallets and wood pallets and shit like that. Like, maybe once or twice a year we were lucky enough to get like somebody's parents out of town and have like an actual house party.
Yeah,
didn't happen. So, you know, if you had to shit, You either carried toilet paper with you in your vehicle, or you would have to drive all the way back home. So people shit a lot outside out there in the
deserts, right?
Near Belen. There's a lot of shitting spots out there. I remember one time, though, I was so fucking hammered, and I just had to poo so bad, and I'm drove out, you know, a little ways away from the party, got out. And I'm holding on to the grill guard in front of my truck, you know.
Yeah.
For support, because I was a little hammered, and squat down. And, I mean, I just unleashed this beast. It was very, very healthy.
Very healthy.
Fantastic. And I wiped my shit up because I was smart and I had my napkins and paper toilet paper with me. Bury it. Go to pull my pants up. And just sopping wet. My pants and underwear are soaked because I didn't aim my dick when I was peeing, when I was squatting over. And it just, just like all of my pants. So instead of just, all right, guys, calling it a night,
gotta go.
I just positioned my truck to where I could sit, like, just in there and still enjoy the party from out the window with no pants on. So I just sat there partying with no pants on in my truck the whole time.
Did
people
anybody
were bringing me beers and smoking bowls, like, you know what I mean? People were kept rotating around.
Did they know what was going on?
Oh, yeah. Oh, shit, yeah. Because I had to put my pants out on the tailgate to dry, you know?
Yeah. Oh. Do they smell amazing afterwards once they're dry? I don't know.
Did you have to sit on any? Like, did you have anything to sit on so that you wouldn't like?
I'm sure there were like some t-shirts or sweats something or some sports paraphernalia. You know what I mean? It was high school, so I always had like crap from practice and stuff.
I was at a party in, gosh, it must have been way back in '95.
Jesus.
And,
hold on real fast. Alan, what were you doing in 95?
I was 3 years old.
Being three somewhere.
And what were you doing in 95?
I was being babysat while my mom worked at the base.
You were being 11 and you were being three.
I was being babysat at that time.
Well, there was
that's that picture that I was
sitting
talking
on babies.
About.
There's this broad. Her name was Nicole.
Simpson?
No.
Brady?
Brown?
Slim Shady? Oh, Nicole Brown. She died.
Not so much. So her name was Nicole, and I knew her from mid school.
It didn't work.
And once I was out of high school, and she was kind of out of high school.
Did you fuck her?
Yes, I fucked the shit out of her, and she was so hot. She was a little hottie. And,
like 103 degrees.
Yes, fucking definitely. And
flu symptomatic.
She had this crazy uncle that was gangster as fuck. He was like 6'3". 250.
So I'm assuming Nicole was brown?
Yes, she was a brown girl. But she was very light-complected, which is kind of what I go for, the light-complectedness.
You're like the milk chocolate.
And so she, her uncle was fucking gangster as fuck. There's some dude that was just walking down his neighborhood one night. We're out there partying, and just some random dude, and he started to walk down this dude's street, and her uncle goes, "Hey, who the fuck are you?" And is it, again, this dude's 6'5", 250. And the guy goes, "I'm just walking through." And the guy was like, "You ain't walking through my fucking neighborhood." And the guy was like, "Okay." And he turned around and he just fucking walked the other way, and it blew my mind. I was like, why the fuck would you even do that to someone? He just wants to walk through your neighborhood, and you're just gonna be like, "No, you can't walk through my fucking neighborhood."
Yeah, everyone wants it. Oh, wait.
I used to run an alley, but not an entire street or neighborhood. That's balls.
Get off of my lawn.
You see this? This means not welcome.
Get off my fucking lawn.
So,
from Grand Torino.
So
oh, sorry, mister.
Thank you for your help.
They were Asian.
Get off my lawn, you fucking gooks. Get away from heads.
How does Clint Eastwood get away with being so blatantly racist in his movies?
Get away from me, you fucking gooks.
Don't you touch her, you bitch! Oh, wait. Did I get off there? Sorry.
I'm not sure what that's from.
Alien? Get away from her, you bitch. That's what it is. Get away. Yeah. Don't touch her. Don't touch her.
This chick...
This is men in black!
This chick... that was a good one.
I'm sorry.
This is men in black!
That video got like 50-something views.
Fuck yeah.
It's not on WorldStar, though. They won't take it.
Why do we not have that isolated, that broadcast? I think it was that video? Yeah, like it just is. Her, what, this is men in black.
Yeah, that should be a soundbite, just this is men in black.
You know, we were watching WorldStar hip-hop videos the other night, and we actually got a different sound clip, because like there was this chick really fucked up on something outside of this hotel trying to say that somebody's car was hers.
Bath salts.
Yeah, something. But then she was like yelling the whole time, this is my husband's car. And then the police start showing up, and then she just sort of says this. Oh, come on, soundboard. I'm a liar because I'm a woman.
It's true. I heard it and I agree with it.
That's my new favorite sound
Stamped.
Clip. Now, if only the soundboard would react in correct time.
So what happened with Nicole that was hot as fuck?
So
the gangster ass uncle?
There was this night where we were partying at her house. It was like, it was like New Year's Eve or something. It was New Year's Eve. That's
you were in
what
high
it was.
Or when?
I was about 19, Attaboy. I think, wait, in 95, 96. I was like 18 or 19. And this girl who her uncle one night when he knew we were gonna fuck, I was like, "Hey man, do you mind if I chill in the room with your niece?" And her uncle was like, "Oh yeah, man, bust a nut. I don't give a fuck." And I was like, "Okay, that shows you the type of
but
person.
He doesn't want anybody walking down his fucking street."
Yeah, well, exactly.
Bang my very knees reasonable. All day long, but keep your fucking shoes off my sidewalk.
Because I was a nice guy, is why. And anyway, we're partying one night, and this dude gets really fucking ripped. It was a typical story. I think we've all had like something like that before, where you are young, you're naive, you think you could drink a lot, and so you imbibe way more than you should. And this kid passed out, you know, after bragging how much he was going to drink. He passed out, like, in the first hour. So they dragged him into the garage to let him sleep it off. And very sympathetic people. They put him on the floor of the garage. They go in to check on him about an hour later. And for some reason, someone puts a decides they see a hanger like right there on the floor, so they pick it up and they start jamming it down the back of his pants to try and wake him up, you know, just give him a little prod in the butt. And when they pulled it out, this log of shit about the size of my fist, you know, about that big, dropped out onto the floor.
So, like, they didn't pull it out of his ass. It was already in his pants?
It was in his pants. Oh. And when they put the hanger in there, it fucking hooked into the solid fucking motherfucker. It was like a hockey puck. He fucking pulled it out, and there's
no
this,
fiber.
Sure enough, there was this turd on the ground. They brought all the girls in there to see it.
Game on.
It was pretty fucking
That's
awesome.
Terrible.
Shit stories. Ugh.
Poop.
You ever shit yourself at a party, Alan?
Not at a party. There was one time me and my buddy, we went to go see a movie. I think it was one of the, it was Freddy versus Jason when that came out.
Oh, yeah.
And I had gotten a pickle from the concession stand. I ate the pickle, but I still wanted more, so I drank the juice.
You're just, oh, like, bad. This whole story is just you making bad decisions.
Yeah.
Freddy versus Jason, pickle at the concession stand. Like
drinking the pickle juice. And then
drinking the juice.
And then I get home, and I'm like climbing around in my tree, and I fart, but it was more than that. And that was because of the vinegar in the pickle juice.
And I bet it, you were like, oh,
and I was in a tree. I was in a tree.
And what was it?
I had to get out of the tree and sort of waddle into the house. It was very messy, embarrassing. Huh? I was in fifth grade.
Shit, that's the last time you shit yourself?
Yeah.
Fuck, good for you, bro.
Yeah, I know.
Dude, I shit myself this year.
What happened?
Like, I shit myself like once a year, probably.
Just for funsies?
Like, no, like, you know what I mean?
When you have
like,
really good
like
sleep.
It's never been like a full-on, like, bah, like a fucking hockey puck. I've never had that in my pants ever, ever, ever. I've never, like, shit myself from being drunk or anything. Just sometimes you eat some fucking greasy, shitty food and you think you got a fart.
Fucking
and
you're
just
greasy.
Like, oh, you know, you're just like, ah, god damn it, now I got to change my underwear. And it's not, like, bad, but it's not looking good.
I'm finding that
not good at all.
That happens. There's a little bit more fecal mist these days. Anytime I have one of those,
yeah,
a little more of a mist.
There's one that's like,
like, but those are the ones that burn.
It's like a ghost.
They're warm as shit.
That's just a concentrated amount of methane. That's why they smell so putrid.
That's why they burn. Yeah,
yeah. Like I had that the other day. I ate like nothing but like burritos and stuff with beans in it, and then the entire next day, because I'd gone without vegetables for a couple days.
Sounds like Chipotle.
Well, you'd think so, but then I went without vegetables for a couple days, and then had you know a couple bean burritos and then some vegetable chili that night, and the next day, Jesus Christ. I'm just glad that the person that I share an office with was at home that day. Because it was bad. Like, you know the farts where you get the chill going up your spine from just that warm burn kind of thing? Yeah. We're losing listeners because of the fart talk, but, you know.
Hey, the show goes where it goes.
The show goes where it goes.
The listeners will not dictate what we talk about.
Yeah.
That's just the way it is. Because we love you guys, but you guys wouldn't respect the
show. If you don't like what we're talking about, that's okay.
Yeah, you guys wouldn't respect the show if we just bowed down to every listener who wanted us to talk about sunshine or something.
Do you want
to
hear this shitty joke I just wrote the other day?
Sure.
Yeah, let's hear it.
Let's do it.
How do cholos get from
they
one
go
floor...
over the speed limit?
Shush. How do cholos get from one floor to the next?
How?
Elevators.
Serio Mente, Holmes. Here's a cool topic. You guys know who Jose Canseco is?
He's the baseball player who shot his finger off.
Former baseball player who shot his finger off.
While cleaning his gun. The problem is you don't disassemble the gun with the magazine in it.
Was it the magazine?
Yes, it was.
Oh.
He had the magazine in the gun and started unracking it and apparently... Either way, you don't put your finger on the fucking trigger even if you're taking apart a fucking pistol. There's no time you need to have your finger on the trigger.
Sean McClain shot a hole straight through his hand.
Yeah.
Good buddy of ours that we grew up with because he's dumb as fuck.
Really?
Wait, you guys know?
No.
No, I know.
I was just agreeing with him.
Me and Griff. Okay. Griff and I grew up with him. Like, Griff lives with the motherfucker.
Okay.
And it was an XD, so, you know, they've got the safety mechanism on the butt of the handle that you have to push that in to either rack it back or pull the trigger or anything like that. So he was trying to rack it to clear the chamber, and I don't even know because I wasn't there firsthand, but I don't know how he fucking did it. But he's driving his truck with his fucking knee trying to fuck with his gun, and he shot a hole through his goddamn hand.
If you're driving with your knee and fucking with you deserve to shoot yourself. God.
Man, I mean, this part is not confirmed, but I'm going to go ahead and assume that drugs and alcohol were involved.
I would assume.
Just because, you know.
Why I would not? Assume that, too.
Because it was Berlin.
Well, this actually happened down in Las Cruces.
Oh.
These are the college years.
So even more.
The college years.
So even more. Of it. Yeah.
Alan, could you pull
education.
Up, could you pull up a finger of Jose, or a finger of Jose Canseco's picture? Yeah, that's what I want. Mm-hmm. A picture of Jose Canseco's finger.
Yeah, get those creepy screws off the screen.
This is Alan's apartment entryway or the next set of Saw?
What?
Hey, try screws. put fingerless instead of finger.
Jose Canseco's finger.
I don't think he would post any pictures of his fingerless hand.
Oh, wait, there it is.
Check it out. It should look something like that.
Oh!
Let's see.
Fuck!
Bring it back over here.
Let me check Twitter then, because that's clearly where you're getting it.
Twitter.
Yeah, but you don't fucking keep a magazine in it while you're taking it apart. That's just
stupid.
Is
that the only way it can happen?
Yes!
Much? Oh, shit.
Well, if there's no bullets in it, you can't fucking shoot yourself.
Yeah,
well,
this
that's kind of how guns work.
It is a two-step process. Mag release, and then... to clear the chamber.
So maybe
drop
he didn't...
Mag,
what if he didn't clear the chamber?
Then... that's possible.
Well, I mean, okay,
but
that's still
that should
only
be an instinct.
One step. There's only two steps. Like, if you miss either of them, that's kind of a big deal.
Two ways to make sure there's no bullets in the gun, and he fucked up half of them.
There's only two steps, but they're both extremely
he fucked up half
important. Yeah.
I thought that was going to be the... to be fair, I thought that was going to be the chick screaming. I thought that was going to be the chick screaming sound. I forgot I haven't updated my list of where the sounds are at. So it was actually like he shot a turkey. That made me hungry. Now I want some turkey. Get a nice turkey leg.
It's coming up soon.
Yeah, it is coming up. I can send you the picture. I would have to email it to you, right?
Well, how do you spell his name?
J-O-S.
Okay, I got it.
Dude. We were so close.
You were very close.
I'm looking.
So Jose Canseco.
Swanson? Samsonite.
Way off.
Started with an S, though.
Jose Canseco shot his finger off while he was cleaning his gun. And in the past couple days, he's been keeping people updated on a situation that developed. What happened was they reattached his finger, or they attempted to. And... I guess he was playing poker at a poker tournament. Fitting. He wouldn't want
to
play blackjack at a poker tournament. People would be like, you're not winning anything.
Yeah, you're getting fucked.
And basically, his finger fell off during the poker tournament. He said it fell off, and some guy had a video of him. Boom, there we are. There's Jose Canseco's finger. I think that was that before it fell off too, right?
So
that clearly looks like after.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I don't know.
What we have learned about this is that one way or another, eventually, snitches do get stitches.
Oh, was he a snitch?
That's good, man.
Yeah,
that
didn't he do
good.
The tell all and call
he
everybody
is,
out on steroids?
Exactly. He's
oh,
the
really?
Reason why the steroids.
Cuckle.
Yes, and basically the only reason why he blew the lid off of the steroids thing was because no baseball team would sign him anymore, and he was done with
loser,
so that, yeah, that's like a trying to take everyone down with you
in a roundabout
exactly.
way.
And
snitches gonna get stitches.
That's exactly what he said he was doing, is he was taking people down with him if he was gonna go down type of thing.
I tried doing that once when I got fired from a car wash.
Who's really? Coming with me?
Yeah, I got fired from a car wash and half of the people that worked there were undocumented.
Oh,
and
shit.
I seriously considered calling somebody about it.
Oh, why would you do that to Walter White?
What? Oh, yeah, that's funny. Oh, wow. Yeah, I see what you're saying.
He had enough
there.
Problems.
He had 98, but I think he needed one more.
Yeah, probably.
Oh,
yeah.
My gosh.
Probably.
Have you guys heard Samuel Jackson read that Go the Fuck to Sleep book.
Yes, that is fucking awesome.
Dude, Brian Cranston did one.
Yeah, it's time to fucking eat.
Yeah, time to fucking eat. The kitchen isn't...
It's fucking time to eat.
Kitchen is fucking closed. Like, that's one of the lines.
I also heard LeVar... Oh, God, what's his name?
Burton?
Burton from the Reading Ringer. He did the Go to Fuck to Sleep, too. That was good.
Kyle, what do you know about DMT?
I know that I wish I heard about it like years before I did because I'm too old to try that shit now.
Really? You think you're too old to try that
shit? Wait, why are you bringing this up? Because that's some heavy shit.
I hung up my hallucinogens shit like that hat got hung up a long ago. All my drug hats are hung up now, man. The only thing I smoke is I just smoke pot now and I barely drink like a couple Coors Lights here and there, but that's it, man.
Yeah, you really tamed it down a little bit.
Yeah, I've done a lot of drugs, but
eventually you kind of have to.
And like I didn't just stop all the hard shit at once. Like there was in phases, certain things just like quit a lot sooner than others.
You kind of get tired of it. And
when was the time that you stopped doing hallucinogenics? Like what year or like what was there something that happened or the last time you tripped maybe? Or
this was about 4.5 years ago or so. I had done acid maybe a handful of times and I've taken mushrooms just hundreds of times.
Wait, a normal handful or a Jose Canseco handful?
Hell, probably more closer to a Jose Canseco one. Let's be honest. Probably closer to 4 than 5, but
it's a big difference.
Done mushrooms, you know, 120 times, a bunch of times. Never had a bad trip on any drug I ever had in my entire life. And then the last 2 times in a row that I did mushrooms, I just had really, really bad trips, and I just, you know,
did you ever
hang this up?
Did you ever binge on mushrooms like a few days at a time of constant?
The like most.
Because I've heard a lot of people.
I did like 3 times in a week, and that was like towards the very beginning when I was that's when shit was still working.
Yeah, that's got to be hard to handle even 3 times for a single week, though. Because I know a lot of people
just food poisoning.
Yeah. Well, that's what it is because it is a poison. Your body does react to it in that sort of way. But I've known a few people that they've talked about doing it for like an entire week or two, like straight. And I know somebody who recently just got back from California where they were out in the mountains for a couple months just every day.
See, that's just like a different breed of person, though, because those hallucinations are generally person like self-containing. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, they don't... After they do... after they go for that long, even more than a couple days on it, they're just different. It's not cool.
Yeah, well, and I mean, after I do mushrooms tonight, tomorrow when I finally wake up, I'm like...
I just want to chill.
I'm good on that for a minute. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like
that's what I did to myself last week with rum.
George Carlin bit?
Oh, wait, what?
George Carlin bit about acid. He's like, you know, acid is awesome because it's self-regulating. You know, you do acid, you'll do acid, you'll do acid. And one day you'll do acid and there's a voice in your brain that says, do not ever do acid again.
Oh, yeah.
And you don't. Like, it's good. And that's basically what happened to me with the hallucinogens. I just was like, yeah, that's enough.
So why'd you bring up DMT?
I was looking through Wikipedia last night, and it kind of came up. And so I was just looking at it, checking out the effects of it, all that stuff. Everything that I've heard, everybody has the same consistent thing, which is
like in their visuals.
There's something or somebody or some
entities.
Sort of
you see entities.
That's like a big thing I hear. I don't know, but it seems like it's far out, man.
It's like a 2-minute adventure, right? Like
10 to 15.
Like I know it's super short. Like that's the only like
it's thing super
that's like I'm like that's the most appealing thing about it to me because like that's the thing with hallucinogens.
It's very
you know?
Short and very intense.
Yeah, but and, you know, like I don't have
dude
from, 8 to 12 hours just to set aside anymore these days for that kind of shit. You know,
that's a lot of time. Huh?
I know somebody who did like a bunch of not a bunch but a good little dose of DMT and then went to an open mic about an hour later. You couldn't even tell that anything had happened.
An hour later though, yeah, because he was just back to sober,
back to completely normal.
I would love to have seen him like do stand up while in the zone, though.
That seems... you would think that would just be impossible, wouldn't it?
Oh, yeah. From what I understand, you're just sunk in a chair. Like, you just... don't worry about him.
that's what I've heard too. So it's kind of
well,
just
you know,
off the topic.
So since you brought it up, I guess I'll break out my DMT.
No, thank you.
real quick, I wanted to go back to the Jose Canseco story because it's made the rounds on like some of the well, basically on Twitter initially, and now it's actually.
Do we know what kind of gun it was?
Gun national.
I think it was a Glock.
Let's see here.
It's a good size fucking round. Yeah.
Jose Canseco,
take a finger off.
Canseco, former baseball slugger who accidentally shot his own finger
with a slug
last month, claims that part of the finger fell off during a poker tournament. I put my finger in the freezer, he wrote. Anyone want appetizers? The joke stems from an incident earlier this week that no one else has reported independently outside of Canseco's tweets. He claims that someone has a video of part of his finger coming off during the poker tournament, yet the footage hasn't been broadcast by anyone. Jose Melendez.
He's full of such shit, man.
You
think so?
Well, do you think if anybody had that video, like, they would not put it online?
Well, they probably have. It just hasn't been,
man,
like...
Well, that's why he's like, oh, somebody's got video. Like, he's just trying to make hype, man.
He probably meant the casino security cameras had video.
Yeah, okay, there you go. That's
somebody cool. had
yeah.
video.
Fucking what a
that
schmuck,
Jew motherfucker,
man.
You!
Take it easy. Here's an answer to that.
Casino, yeah.
Here's an answer to that question. Jose Melendez, Canseco's representative, told CNN that the ex-player's camp has the video and may sell it to media outlets.
Oh, so they have the video. Somebody means me. Like, he probably planned that shit.
Possibly.
He planned
like
for his finger
one.
To fall off?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Well, maybe he put, like...
Come on, like... I have to imagine that it's got to be a very violent, aggressive gesture to get a finger to just fall off after professional doctors have reattached it.
Well, there's
and
no bone.
Right there,
the bone
look,
was detached.
You can see there's, like, rods sticking out of the fronts. And so, I mean, like, that. I'm sure they didn't just, like, put it together with a stick of fucking gum. You know what I mean? Like, it was sewed on there. Like, and I just don't see anything happening. And, like, how hard are you bluffing in your poker game, your fucking shit falls off like that. Like, come on, man.
That would be a good bluff, though, if your finger fell off.
He's just such a fucking skeezy douchebag. I fucking hate you, Jose Canseco. There it is. Kyle Merrell hates Jose Canseco. And if he wants to fucking find me, call Potential Problem Cop.
You know what we could do for you? You know what we could have?
We have a web show war.
Wait, does he have
a web show war?
Do you think you could take Jose Canseco now? I mean, he's still pretty buff.
He looks pretty susceptible to gunshot wounds, so yeah, I think I could take him.
You know what? I heard that his left hook is very weak right now.
Oh.
Yeah, he's a little bit. For now, all the world has to work from is Canseco's Twitter feed, the same place where just a few days ago he was opining that, I remember I actually posted this on Facebook because I was looking at Twitter and I was like, Jose Canseco says... is talking fucking comet travel. What the fuck does he know about it, dude? But a few days ago, he was opining that comet transport is the key to our survival in a tweet.
That's a reliable source.
And that was because of
because he watched Interstellar and then saw these guys land the probe on that comet.
On the comet, yeah.
Asteroid.
And now it ran out of energy, like because it landed in a shadow.
Yeah.
So now it's idle.
Well,
only like
that,
a day, two days into
that
it.
Anchors didn't hook right, so like it when it touched the super
bounced
super low
twice.
It bounced like fucking.
Yeah, they had to
balls,
they had to correct the bouncing twice, but then it anchored in.
Well, we know it's on there. We just don't know where. It's in the shadow. Fuck it.
It started.
How many millions of dollars was that down the drain? I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No, that's okay. That was actually going to be our next story. Probably it starts with his admission Friday that my finger fell off. He tweeted during a poker tournament the previous night. Canseco then tweets, my finger should have been amputated from the beginning. It was very loose with no bone to connect it. It was also smelling really bad. That was after he put it in his wife.
Oh,
his wife. That's the joke.
My wife
got a dirty cooch.
My wife.
And for good measure, the one-time Oakland A's basher shared a gruesome photo Saturday of his finger before it fell off. I bet a long time ago you could easily lose a finger or hand or even your life in a poker game if you couldn't pay up, Conseco joked. That's a good joke. It all stems from an incident last month when Conseco accidentally shot himself in a finger on his left hand while cleaning a handgun.
God, don't you wish he was trying to see if a bullet was in there? Like...
He is famous because he was the 1988... he won the Rookie of the Year award in 86 and was the league MVP 2 years later.
I don't give a fuck. I wasn't even born.
Finished his 17th season career with 450 home runs. 500 is usually gets you into the hall. Back into the public spotlight.
I wasn't born yet. It's not important.
Where's the Cody Dev
clip? Are you a 90s baby?
Yeah. We just talked about
95.
This.
That's right.
92.
No, 95. You were three. That's what I'm saying. Math is hard.
It is. I don't like math. Don't know the price of gas.
I remember the first time I banged a chick that was born in the 90s, I felt kind of skeezy.
Really?
Yeah, just for a second, though.
Oh, yeah.
Until I was inside.
Up until it felt good.
Yeah, I remember this was like... I was like, when that development happened, you're kind of like, whoa. Like, when you find out you banged someone that was born in the 90s, you're like, oh, shit, that's kind of... I mean, it's hot, but it's a milestone.
Way to go, Kyle. I feel old.
It looks like... okay, did you want to do the Comet story next? Do you have any Comet. Facts on that?
Did anybody ever clean their house with Comet?
What is it called?
Or were we Ajax? Well,
the Philae Probe. The Philae Probe. Is that what it's called? That's what it's called here on the CNN story. The Philae Probe.
Just don't undercook it.
Where does it say probe?
That first paragraph. Pretty much like the last.
It does say probe. Just so you guys can... I confirmed that it does say probe on this new story.
Fuck. So, let's see here.
Oh, hey. John, do you want to see what I did the other day?
Yeah.
What'd you do? What happened? Are you okay?
Yeah.
Are you going to be sick?
It's a picture of...
What happened?
Oh, hey, that's pretty fucking awesome. Right? Holy Jesus.
Dude. What?
Let me hit Alan some of this action.
Fucking
whore!
Yeah! Yeah! That's what we're looking at. Jesus, that's some twerking. Oh my God. That is
nice. Right. Nice.
She just seems fantastic.
Like, no, yeah, that's the best because usually, like, I have to sneak my phone up, like, you know, just like be hitting it from doggy or whatever for a minute and just be like.
But she was like, no, take a picture.
She was like, no, turn the light on.
Nice.
You'll get better lighting.
Let's color correct this shit.
What? That shit.
A little interlude there, folks. For you folks that at home that didn't get a chance to see that, it was basically Kyle was basically showing us something cool. You guys didn't get to see it. Too bad.
It was very cool.
The Philae Probe may have ended its mission prematurely. It always sucks when a probe ends prematurely.
Oh, doesn't it?
Yeah, I should know. Its batteries have run down like a single woman's vibrator.
Bitch.
Its batteries have run down.
She can't afford batteries.
Philae has
it's a
fallen.
Love wand.
It's Philae. Would you say that's Philae?
I would say it's, yeah.
Okay. Has fallen into idle mode for a
American
a potentially
problems podcast
long silence.
Oh,
but problems podcast is better. In this mode, all instruments and most systems on board are shut down. This might not change. Philae was supposed to transmit data from Comet 67/P for 9 months as it passed the sun running on solar power, but it did not get its place in the sunlight that scientists had hoped for.
It lasted 2 days.
They did not.
Not 9 months.
They didn't plan this mission very well. Fucking Europeans.
You know, Kyle, they had to go 310 million miles with something about 9 feet by 9 feet big to to land on something that's just over a mile and a half. That's good accuracy, but you can't really account for spin of the comet like that.
The probe's landing didn't
they
go
should've.
As...
They got computers.
Yeah, those fucking nerds. Computers.
Nerds!
The probe's landing...
They are nerds. They should have known. Fucking nerds, you should have known that it wasn't going to work.
They suck.
And now you get a horrible, fucking wedgie.
You had one central probe. Point of light, and you guys landed on the opposite side of it.
That's the worst probing since Bill Cosby offered someone some sleeping pills.
Some sleeping pudding.
Let's come make, here, Rudy.
Let's make some ass pudding.
The probe's landing didn't go as planned this week after Philae detached from the Rosetta orbiter. It took two bounces away from its designated landing spot.
Isn't that exactly what happened in, fucking, what is it? The asteroid movie with Bruce Willis.
Oh, yeah.
Armageddon. Didn't they bounce a couple times?
I was more of a deep impact man myself.
They did bounce a couple times in that,
they
right?
They did. That's what happened. They got the landing wrong.
My question is, did they use the same method they used to attach into it where it shoots harpoons into it? Or did they just hope that the blasters would keep them on there?
See the outside deals on the legs? Those are anchors. But
I mean in Armageddon. Armageddon.
I don't know.
Yeah, I don't remember.
You know what I think, though? I think that perhaps just like the moon landing, this shit was hoaxed and they based it on fucking Armageddon.
It was like a conspiracy is what it is, Alan.
The only reason they were like, yeah, that shit bounced and we lost it. You know what I mean? So they can have a good excuse and they'd be like, oh, people saw Armageddon. They'll buy that shit. Bruce Lewis fucking killed it. Bruce Willis and Ben Affleck.
All we did is capture a screenshot from the movie Armageddon and put it as the ESA pictures.
That's all it was.
I thought these guys were supposed to be nerds. How come you're making them sound dumb as shit?
The probe's landing didn't go as
Jesse Ventura.
The probe's landing didn't go as planned this week after Philae detached from the Rosetta orbiter. Oh, I already know. The lander remains unanchored on the surface at an undetermined orientation.
It remains unanchored?
That's what they said.
What's the name?
What?
The thing?
Filet.
Shio.
It ended up in a shady spot of Comet 67P.
It means there was a bunch of people sitting on their porches drinking 40s.
Originally.
Intimidatingly.
Originally.
That sounds racist.
It was in a shady spot.
Originally, it was supposed to have 7 hours of light per comet day, which lasts just 12.4 hours.
Comet day?
Now it's exposed only 1.5 hours a day. That's likely not enough to juice up Philae. The rechargeable secondary battery. Way to hit a home run there, Kyle.
Oh, God.
Good timing.
Regular.
I was staring at the picture.
There is one last hope.
Is it a new hope? Star Wars?
No. Mission controllers sent commands to rotate the lander's main body to which the solar panels are fixed. This may have exposed more panel area to sunlight. Despite its wall-eyed positioning, Philae transmitted data and black and white photos back to Earth and ESA scientists.
Why is it sending black and white photos?
They don't have a fucking...
It was a 2004 mission.
Is that when they launched
it? That took 10 years.
Holy fuck.
10 years to get 310 million miles. That's how much of an accomplishment.
NASA game up.
The pictures appear to indicate it landed in some sort of shadow, possibly the shadow of a transformer? Oh, a cliff.
Transsexual.
My bad. Transsexual.
Tranny.
Blah, blah, blah. The lander was racing against the clock to meet as many of the core science goals as possible before the primary battery was exhausted.
With like a 30-minute delay. So like they'd send a command and 30 minutes later it would happen. And then another 30 minutes later you get a response. Yeah.
Gotta love them radio waves.
It takes a full hour to know that the command you told it to do worked.
Yeah, no shit.
That's why I like the space shit. Because of, like, all the different shit. It's just so far away.
You know what I like? I think that...
it's farther away from the sun than we are.
I'm...
By twice as much, at least.
The German Space Agency, which operates Philae for ESA... Thank you. ...has taken a lighthearted approach to the battery's impending doom.
What they say, we'll just get a Chicano's car to jumpstart it.
Yeah.
It was in a shady spot.
They're going to get their Uncle Theo to push start it.
It's Uncle Theo.
It's a manual, so we can just pop the clutch. Pop the clutch, Holmes.
Use Theo from Breaking Bad.
Boom.
Filet's Twitter account tweeted, "I'm feeling a bit tired. Did you get all my data? What about the mama?"
Oh, I wanted to say that like 5 minutes ago, but I didn't because I knew it would suck.
"I might take a nap," a post read. "So much hard work. Ugh. Getting tired. My battery voltage is approaching the limit soon now."
Is this thing like Dave from 2001 A Space Odyssey where it's just sort of tweeting on its own? I would hope that would actually be the fucking... Because that would be worth it not having... Like, being all this money put into it to send it there, that would almost be worth it dying, is the fact that the actual thing is tweeting. Knowing that it's just the nerds.
I guess if we do have a robot that, like, gets to, like, self-realization and, like, you know what I mean, a consciousness, blah, 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 best place for it is on a fucking comet, 300 million miles away or whatever.
I think the scientists are doing some live-action role-play and just calling themselves the lander, so they're, like, jumping on the fat guy. To reenact the landing.
Yeah.
And then they're tweeting as the lander so it doesn't get confusing. Yeah.
Let's see here. "It's possible that the conditions may change as the comet moves closer to the sun, making it possible to charge the secondary battery."
That's how light works.
"Then Filet could awaken from its deep slumber and send data and photos back to Earth. Even with the lander out of commission, the Rosetta orbiter that carried the Filet lander will continue to transmit observations of the comet. Rosetta took off from Earth 10 years ago aboard an Ariane. Yeah.
Superior.
5 rocket." There's an E at the end, so I don't know which way to go on that one. And traveled 6.4 billion with a B, billion miles before rendezvousing with the comet in August. That's kind of what Alan was talking about. The lander, the Filet lander, separated from the orbiting Rosetta about 3:30 a.m. Wednesday and first landed on the comet 7 hours later. The lander weighs 220 pounds and is the size of a domestic washing machine. The target comet is only 4 kilometers or 2.5 miles in diameter. The spaceship is named after the...
That's big as my dick.
Boom! Size of household dishwasher, bitches.
Is named after the Rosetta Stone and inscribed piece of volcanic rock found in Egypt in 1799.
I thought it was a language program.
I thought so, too. That allowed scientists to decipher...
This was named after the language program.
Hieroglyphics, that's right. And thus understand the ancient Egyptian culture.
You know, we would better understand hieroglyphics if they were soberglyphics.
Yeah.
Smoking all would be a little more clear.
Hey, so what's the name of that comet?
Filet?
No, comet.
That's the comet.
Oh, yeah.
That's the probe.
Oh. Yeah, you know what? Oh, the comet is like...
Something with a 69.
10P slash or something?
No, there's a 69 in there.
KFC 10-piece.
Come on, 69. Somebody tell me something with a 69.
The comet 67/P.
Oh, motherfucker. I was going to say, it'd be awesome to land Felatio on the 69.
So close.
Maybe you if two so more close. Show up, they'll rename it.
All right. Well, we'll just wait for not the next comet, but the one after that.
Yeah. We'll land one on Halley's comet. Why hasn't anybody decided to land a fucking probe on Halley's comet? Because it actually gets so close to us.
I probed this girl named Halley's comet once.
You mean you probed Halley's comet?
Did you get in at that tail?
It was good.
Comets have tails, don't they?
They do. They're very bright tails, which usually means they have like a very colorful tramp stamp.
You know what? Trannies and tramps and stuff. Those have been the second time I've been reminded of this. Lately, I've been watching this tranny porn, but
Bailey J,
because it's straighter than straight porn. Like whenever it's a tranny banging a broad.
That's
like straight porn, but straighter. It's even better.
That is true.
Yeah.
Huh.
You know what I mean? Think about the titty to dick ratio.
All right, hold on. Just
trust me, I've been doing this for a while. It's pretty awesome. Now when it's two trannies.
Give a second of silence. So we can really just take in that point.
Take it in.
Yeah, when it's
tranny porn, when a transsexual with a dick is fucking a chick, is more straight than just watching guy on girl.
Yes.
Definitely.
That is one hell of a point. You are not wrong.
This has been
God.
I've been on this for about a month.
God damn it, Kyle. That is a fucking...
It's a revelation is what that is.
Yeah. You know, I hope my buddies, the Christian bros, end up, like, trying to hit on a post-op because they're so against gays. Like, they're the reason that saying gay and faggot has such a negative connotation.
Still.
They still use it in such a hateful way. I hope they eventually... I hope they talk to a chick and they don't know that it's a dude. That's what I hope.
Oh, I hope that they
get
it's
tricked.
A dude and they just kind of pretend like no one else knows, so they just go with it.
But that doesn't work because, you know, God knows. According to them.
I hope that they meet some chick who's a dude, but they're really attracted to them, and so they come to this moral dilemma of is it wrong to bang dicks with,
like just straight fall in love, like, yeah, spend my life with this.
Yeah, but
dude,
God says it's wrong to, like, bang dicks with another dude. So he's, like, deeply conflicted. He goes on, he gets married, and then he thinks about this dude. And every time he's fucking his wife, he has a hard time climaxing because he really, really just wants a dick against his dick instead of, you know, being inside a vagina. So all the rest of his life, he goes through life being sexually unfulfilled and kind of, like, walking through his marriage all the while thinking about hard dicks being pressed against him.
Hmm. This sounds like it's hitting a little close to home here, John.
No, I'm just saying. I hope that's what.
That sounds like a lot of experience.
That was a lot of justifying.
Well, you know, I'm not saying I don't know how to have a good time. I'm just saying.
And, you know, it's interesting. I've been there was this movie on Netflix called The Unbelievers, and it's about Richard Dawkins, who's like a, you know, biologist.
Wait, The Unbelievers?
The Unbelievers.
Is that okay?
It's not a Justin Bieber documentary.
The Unbelievers.
Unbelievers. But it's about Richard Dawkins and this physicist, Lawrence Krauss. Mm-hmm. And all it really is them debating.
Allison's dad, sure.
Sure. All it really is them having, like, a different, you know, sort of debate conversations about the way religion affects society kind of thing. And that's going at it from an atheist point of view, or as they call it, an anti-theist point of view. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I sort of got into a loop of watching a bunch of, like, these guys on their own, and there was that guy Lawrence Krauss on an episode of Q&A, like, and it was all pretty much people from different religious backgrounds and a moderator, and this physicist was the only, like, atheist in the whole group. And throughout all of it, different, like, there was a gay bishop from America, there was a hardcore conservative, like, Catholic priest who believes, you know, Old Testament, New Testament, book of all this stuff.
Children are being fucked in Old Testaments.
Yeah, but and then you have the astrophysicist who, you know, comes at it from a very unbiased point of view where, like, I don't. It was a really interesting episode.
Atheists are just as biased as religious fanatics. It's like an agnostic is going to be the one that's not as biased.
But one of the debates was in science or in medicine. Would you trust a doctor who has personal beliefs of one thing that would contradict medicine? However, they, you know, since their profession is being a doctor, would you trust that their medical evaluation would be 100% up to par with an atheist's who was a doctor? So there was just, like, a bunch of that kind of back and forth going on, and it's just amazing to see, because, like, a bunch, almost three quarters of the panel was religious on this show, and they pretty much all kept going back to the whole you're probably just born straight, it is a choice kind of thing. But yeah, and then this,
but
it was funny. One of the first points that they brought up was the super hardcore conservative preacher guy. Like, the first question was, "So you were born straight?" to this guy, and he was like, "Well, of course you're born straight. Anything after that is merely a choice of preference." But then the physicist goes, like, on a rebuttal of, "Well, there's over 160 different documented mammals that have gay sex just for no reason, and specifically sheep's."
Yeah,
because
there's a whole
sheep's
book
are, yeah,
that.
Yeah,
I saw that.
Yeah, it was a pretty interesting conversation.
Oh my god.
What?
Like who the fuck would choose that for themselves? Like who just chooses a life of ridicule
or
fucking
hate.
Like hate and like just
like hating different people just because of their different choice. Yeah.
Well, no, I mean that's what I'm saying. Well, like not even, no one ever yeah, like yeah. Oh, being gay is a choice. Like who the fuck would choose that? Like, you know what I mean?
Just
like,
to hate
oh,
other
that's
people.
That's what I want to do. I want to choose something that's going to make my life harder for me.
I think in a way it has to do with people being threatened. Like just they're a little bit insecure of whether or not they think they would be persuaded by a gay person, that they just want to put up all the barriers possible.
That's bullshit. That's silly. I know firsthand that anybody can be persuaded by a gay.
Yeah, if you're drunk enough.
Well, I
you're like, fuck it, I don't care right now.
Or if I'm tired enough, or yeah. if I'm hungry enough, or if I'm lonely.
If there's any number of variables, you'll probably be like, all right, you know what?
If I'm bored.
In fact, like, if I'm on a podcast.
Fellas, no specific fellas, reason. Fellas,
if I got time before I fuck a chick.
Yeah. Or after. During.
I didn't want to announce this like right here on an episode of
you're a mo?
Potential problem. No.
Oh.
That comes later. Why do I have to announce that? I didn't want to announce this on the show today, but since you guys are on the subject, I just want to let you know I have on IFC, I have a show coming out.
Independent film channel?
Independent fag channel.
Oh.
I have a show coming out. Yeah, I have it's going to be a series. It's going to be once every other week, but it's on Wednesdays the first 2 weeks, and then the last 2 weeks it's on
How many
Fridays.
Hours a day on those days?
It's a half an hour.
That's all?
Knowing John, it's going to be a mini series.
And it's called Out. Is what it's called.
Okay, Lucas.
It's called Out, and it's the tagline is "You being gay isn't a choice, but being fabulous is."
Yeah,
that's like gonna that. Be the tagline. Pretty good, right?
Being fabulous is a choice.
Thanks. So you guys should watch.
We should get cheers for my miniseries joke, though. That was pretty good.
Miniseries
was all right.
You know what? Miniseries are like fucking cool because they're not TV shows, so no
Says
one's
the guy with the little dick.
What? Wait, why did you say that about yourself? No, but miniseries are pretty fucking cool because they're not like TV shows. Like a sitcom, like that runs its course, you know, and it loses momentum. But like a miniseries,
like a good Hatfield and McCoy.
Yeah,
everybody loves Raymond. Never ran its course. I watched a lot of it.
Really? That show ate balls.
No, it didn't.
I'm going to go ahead and agree with the gentleman to my right.
Like I said,
shows that I just never got into.
You were adults at the time. I was a kid still.
There's only one thing that pisses me off more than this show. It's
the one that you're on right
people,
now?
No,
yeah,
no,
potential
no.
problem.
TV show.
Me
TV
off,
show. The only thing that pisses me off more than the show itself is how many people fucking love this show. I hate The Big Bang Theory.
Really?
Fucking hate it. It's so stupid. Yeah. Like, it's not even funny. They just throw in a big word, and because most people don't know what the fuck it means, like, oh,
they really
nerds.
They really play off of the awkward nerd scientist stereotype very, very heavily. I'll agree with you there.
It's just not funny.
Well, that's why it's hard.
It has smart humor.
Galecki hasn't been on a show since Roseanne.
It has smart humor.
Not really. It's just disguised as smart humor so that dumb people think it's smart and then laugh at it.
Well, that's the thing is you have to sort of tailor to the plight of the common man, even though these characters in the show are so, quote-unquote, incredibly smart.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's part of Hollywood's job in a way to make things that everyday people wouldn't necessarily come into contact with more relatable. So I kind of understand your argument of it being not very good, like how they do kind of tailor to the dumb person, but like that show does piss off a lot of people.
Well, and it's hard to make like a decent sitcom. If you have a multi-camera sitcom, it is fucking hard to make that entertaining and not fake as shit. Because a lot of those shows, even my favorite show of that genre recently was Two and a Half Men. And before Ashton Kutcher, like Charlie Sheen was the bomb, but it was formulaic, and it was the same shit you've seen in a thousand other sitcoms where, boom, Alan says something stupid or straight, and then
Charlie Sheen says, about me in general.
The different Alan. And then Charlie Sheen says something hilarious and outrageous or crazy or the punchline.
Wacky.
And talks about Alan mooching.
The reason why it worked is because we gave a fuck about Charlie Sheen. We're like, yeah, Charlie Sheen's fucking crazy. You would just go to his house and fucking party with him, and then it'd be great. It would be fucking great, dude. Like, who wouldn't love to have $1 million and tell their boss, fuck you, I do what I want. Fuck you, I'm a bad mouth you. Do whatever I want. That's everybody's fucking, exactly.
While,
get the fucking
while
in.
Under contract.
While
under contract.
But so my point is that show was it wasn't a great show, but it was good.
And it was all right.
It's something I'd watch.
Good
you know?
Enough.
But it's not
good enough. To me, good enough.
What's that from?
The Goonies.
Oh yeah, that's right.
When they escape the evil brother.
But
what a dick.
How
yeah,
many
really.
How many shows?
I had two older brothers, fucking assholes.
Were they like Josh Brolin types?
Josh Blue.
He needed the money.
Kind of like one was just a nerd and the other was just an asshole.
Can you
and they both beat me up.
Can you think of another sitcom that was multi-camera, you know, that was kind of like your typical sitcom? I throw Roseanne in there.
Happy Days.
Heffernan.
Yeah, but was that was really
King
good.
Of Queens.
King of Queens.
King of
yeah.
Queens.
Yeah.
No, like King of Queens,
Heffernan.
Really?
I like Heffernan.
It was okay. It was okay. Awesome. He was very relatable. He was a postage man.
IPS. I'm a fan of any fat guy with a smoking hot wife.
Yeah. Especially an Italian
better
wife.
Better than Raymond. Way better than Everybody Loves Raymond.
Yeah, she was a little
and
more
she was
edgy.
Such a cunt to him all the time.
That's the point.
Yeah. Like, I want a wife who's going to fucking...
Do you know how much weight she gained and lost in the series of that show?
Like,
No, that actress lost and gained so much different...
She was pregnant
as much as a real wife,
really?
Right?
Was that what it was?
Yeah.
Oh shit!
They did really good with the camera angles to make it like.
Well,
look
of course,
like
during
just got a little bigger.
Of course, during the major parts of the pregnancy, they don't film. You know, you got to have time off.
She was pretty fucking far along.
Oh yeah, you could definitely see that she was pretty hefty, but it did. You know, looking back,
she
it didn't
just,
really look like pregnancy. It just looked like she was fat.
You thought she was just like eating more steaks and Coronas or something.
I thought the success was getting to her hips.
Did you guys ever see this one? I believe it was called Still Standing.
Still Standing.
Yeah, that it was like. Got not much love, not a lot of play.
What
but I
network
thought it was
so
fucking
no.
hilarious.
What network was it on?
And I don't even know. I remember just catching it like on cable, like rerun style.
Huh.
I don't know the guy's name, but he was King Baratheon from Game of Thrones, you know, before he died.
Ahmad Rashad?
From the first season, you know, the first king. Like,
I'm not a Game of Thrones
person.
Ned
Stark!
There was somebody that I worked with about a year and a half ago, and they had a Game of Thrones calendar with the midget on it. And
Peter Dinklage.
I thought that was like the Hobbit or a Lord of the Rings character, and I asked him about it. He's like, "No,
Hello?
Dude, that's." He's like, "No, dude, that's Game of Thrones." A little nerdy dude. And I'm like, "Well,
it looks like Willow to me, man."
Yeah, it looks like fucking Bilbo.
Out of the way, Peck.
Bilbo Baggins.
Boy? What?
Do you take me for some conjurer of cheap tricks?
Cheap Trick? I like that band.
Cheap Trick?
It was, what's the record on that? Five-necked guitar?
For Cheap Trick?
Yeah.
What do you...
You know how he has that five-neck guitar or four-neck guitar?
No, I didn't.
You didn't? You've never seen that shit?
No.
The guitars for Cheap Trick? Have you seen that? You've seen that shit, right, Kyle?
Not played just in pictures. I remember in... magazine or some bullshit.
Jimmy Page had one when he would play Stairway to Heaven on
Wasn't
stage.
That four?
One was
that
a 12
was
string and one was a regular.
That was
guitar.
A double neck guitar.
I know that one was, but I'm talking about the Cheap Trick guy who has like.
Look at that shit.
Yeah, there you go.
Why would you need that? One of them doesn't even have frets. It's like an original cello bass, the bottom one, where it just one long boom. You could pick any fucking note and probably be wrong.
God damn.
It's a little bit ridiculous. Huh?
Cheap Trick. I know Steve Vai had that invisible guitar, the see-through one.
Oh, really?
That one was really cool because it had like a little green LED light in it.
Oh, yeah.
So it kind of made it illuminate.
Was that
kind of green?
It was probably from the 80s where everybody was down with LED lights and see-through shit. Like, do you remember those phones, those see-through phones?
Yeah.
There's
you know
one.
What I remember about the 80s was that lots of right angles.
Is yeah. That... Yeah.
But, yeah, a stupid clear plastic phone that you could see all the innards. You could see the guts.
And there was...
Clear plastic phone?
Yeah, that was, like, a big thing in the 80s.
And there was, like, a light inside of it.
Hamburger phones and shit like that. They had, like, a lot of, like, novelty phones.
Well, because that was the beginning of the personalization of your phone before it was a mobile phone.
Hello. Hello, sir.
Hello, this is an old-style phone here.
Operator.
Operator, get me down for an abortion of two Negroes.
Can you believe the sound fidelity of this old-school telephone? It is so new with the technology.
The Edison way.
So, see,
you have to block off your nose from being able to hit the microphone, so all you really hear is the high end.
Maybe it's some sort
block
of
it off.
Maybe it's 2014 and you guys should get your head.
John, we need to work on your microphone technique.
Oh, fuck.
You need to learn how to do it properly.
Now you sound like
you're
a munchkin.
You're supposed to make no air gets through.
What guild do you
I am from the Lollipop Guild.
those guys, the Lollipop Guild were troopers.
They were
having to carry around those big ass lollipops that are bigger than them.
Have you seen the
you never see him licking them.
You know you don't.
Well, they're always just shouldering those.
I saw him licking them, but
it was
not the lollipops.
Plastic. That's lollipops to the munchkins.
Just hey, those aren't real lollipops, and just like the munchkins holding them aren't real people. All right, they could still lick it. I was reaching for that one, guys.
Yeah, that's all right. Yeah. There's a lot of reaching on this show.
Around.
Yeah.
Redemption.
I was waiting to say
you
it, but I didn't.
Go on a jerk off joke and save yourself.
Always, always. Usually, the joke is the fact that you're jerking yourself.
Oh, dude.
I don't know what.
We were so close.
To what? I didn't know that.
We
edging.
We almost lost Bono.
What happened? Oh, turbulence?
We'll get back to edging in a minute.
We almost lost him. So close.
Speaking of it.
He was in a private jet. It would have been awesome. That's why I said
it wasn't even
close.
It was the cargo door. It wasn't even the passenger door.
Whatever, like, it was closer than we've been before. He was in his private jet, and the cargo door just, like fucking shot off. And
First of all, why would they have a car door?
Cargo?
Oh, okay.
Cargo with
Never
which
mind.
To put your cargo in.
Gotcha.
Foodie plane.
It was a cargo door flying over Fargo.
Yeah,
oh,
I didn't hear the go part.
Cargo there, don't you know? Fargo there.
So anyway,
barbecue.
The cargo door opens up, right?
Yeah,
that's about it. And then
and
he
then
lost a bag or two.
Two suitcases. He got two suitcases that he's missing there over Germany somewhere.
Huh. And it was just Bono?
Yeah.
It was
him and four other people.
One of those suitcases is just straight sunglasses.
Probably.
That's what I guess.
But, like, you know that jet
that's
that
pretty
you
can... good, dude.
Like, you know in Grand Theft Auto San Andreas, the jet that you can fly around, the small one?
Yeah.
That's what he was riding in.
Ah.
Yeah.
It
was
a
cargo
jet,
door.
Like, you know what I mean? It wasn't, like, just a prop plane.
Yeah.
It was a jet.
Legit jet. You know, 12,000 feet.
I don't like jets. They don't seem to go as fast as a regular airplane.
You know,
and they're not as stable because it's so small.
Do you know why that's weird? They speak so highly of you.
Yes. I've heard nothing but good things from jets.
The jets like me, but I don't like jets.
Yeah.
I've only flown on one jet, and that was from here to Oklahoma City, which is like an hour and a half flight, 2 hours. So much fucking turbulence
in a
jet.
What was worse, the jet ride over or being in Oklahoma?
Being in Oklahoma with the Bible Belt family.
Ah.
Evangelical preachers. They frequently, at least once a year, do missions to Africa to go tell people what you don't believe is wrong.
Fucking Ebola bringing back motherfuckers.
Yeah, that's why I'm glad this year they couldn't go. They can't go
they wouldn't have come
back. They can't go ruin people's lives and tell them what you already believe is wrong. If you don't believe us,
sure
you're going to go
this
to hell.
This is America. You can tell anybody whatever the
this
fuck
This is
you
America.
Want.
That's Africa. It doesn't apply like that.
Now, Alan, I think I should be the first to interject because of my church upbringing that if they don't save these people, if they don't teach them about Jesus, if they don't teach them about Jesus,
and
much like our prayer candle
and
here,
the Ewok.
Get folks, that Ewok off of there.
If they don't teach them about Jesus, they can never be saved and they'll go to hell, even though they don't know about Jesus until they're told.
You know.
Like, unless they're told, then they won't know they can be saved.
Yes.
And now they'll be saved.
That's part of the rule is if you don't know about these religions and you don't accept them because you don't know, you are in no fault. But only if you know about it and reject it are you in fault. What the fuck is that about? Going to different places and telling people that paradox where that now what I told you, you have to believe or else you're going to go to this place that I just told you about,
Alan,
once you die.
Can you do me a favor?
Yeah.
Stop siding with the fucking heathens.
Yeah.
The heathens.
It's all about cheese sauce.
Haven't you ever read A Heart of Darkness?
No.
Really?
I read Night by Elie Wiesel.
Oh, dude, it's a quick, easy read. It's like 76 pages. Have you seen Armageddon Now?
No.
We were just talking, but that's the one with Bruce Willis, right?
You mean Apocalypse Now?
Apocalypse Now.
Yes, I just recently saw that.
Oh, man, I do that all the time.
Dude,
I always,
like,
talk about something and just, like... Like somebody was talking about black superheroes at one of the open mics, and
yeah.
I was like, Hitchcock?
Oh, yeah, Hitchcock, that's right.
And they're like, Hancock. I'm like, yeah, that's what I meant. I do that shit all the time.
The guy from
The
Incredibles?
One earlier today. What did I say?
Sam Jackson from The Incredibles was one. He was the black superhero.
Oh, yeah. That doesn't count because that's a fucking cartoon.
Blade? Where's my super suit at? It's the one that says bad motherfucker.
Woo! Are we up on time?
No.
Are we good?
Because we started late, remember?
Oh, yeah, that's
right. We got 10 minutes.
I'm reading The Event.
Oh. Fuck The Event.
That's what it is.
We're The Event.
So, about 8 years ago, I ran into a buddy that I hadn't seen since high school. He graduated a year or two before me, so we hadn't seen each other in about, you know, 3 or 4 years. And it was like a random Tuesday or Wednesday night, and we decided just to go downtown. I think we went to the library and had just a couple beers. It wasn't even a big deal. Standing out front having a smoke, and my buddy Gio Schifino, he worked in a bike shop, so he's like, you know, one of those pedal heads.
Yeah.
And he had recently broke his arm. Doing shit on bikes, so he had like the cast and the sling and everything. And some bum came up and like was asking for money. He like pedaled up on his bike, and so Gio just started talking with him about bike shit. And they were just chatting for a second, and I was standing right here, right next to him, but just talking to my other buddy, not really paying attention to their conversation. And all of a sudden, I see the bum just kind of like lean over and start pushing fucking Gio like in his shoulder. And I was, you know, motherfucker's got his arm broken. So I was like, hey, like, chill out, man. And I put my hand on his chest, like, chill out, man. And like halfway through talking, he just said, just cocked me right in the fucking mouth.
The bum did?
Yeah, the bum just clocked me right in the mouth.
Was he a big guy, small guy?
He's about your size.
Okay.
No, not tiny, not huge, just,
yeah.
You know, average guy. He must have been wearing a ring or something, because, like, it didn't even really drop me back that much. You know, I just kind of like,
I've been hit with a ring before. That's not fun.
I was just like...
Cock ring.
What the fuck? And I spit into my hand, my tooth.
Uh-huh. Shit.
This is a fake. This whole thing is fake.
Really?
Yeah. So I spit that in my hand, and I'm just like flabbergasted. Like, what the fuck just happened?
Why the fuck would that guy do that?
And like, I'm looking at my tooth, and I look up at my buddy Gio, and he goes, fucking hit him! So I was like,
fucking
yeah, that's a good idea.
Him.
So I come back and I just, I just start cranking this bum.
Yeah.
And he drops to the ground, and I was like, good motherfucker. And when I stop, and he kicks me in the back of the fucking leg, and I was like, are you kidding me? I turned around, and he went to kick me again, and I caught his foot, and I just, kicked that dude in the face so fucking hard. And these two giant black guys come running across from Maloney's, you know, like, and they wrap me up, and I was
like it's
no.
Your fault.
Yeah, he's like, well, fuck, man, you can't be doing that. And I was like, yo, and I spit my tooth back out because I put it
you
back
put
in
it
my
back.
Mouth. You know what I mean? I don't want to lose
it's
it.
Like
I was
a chiclet.
I didn't know if it was like a finger. I don't know if
yeah.
I could attach it or what, you know. So
put it in milk and drive to the dentist or some shit,
and I was
right?
Like, yo, no, this fucking guy just sucker punched me, and I showed him my tooth, and he's like, oh, well, go handle your business, boy. And I was like, I was trying to, man.
Was that guy already fucked up?
He was fucked up and, like, took off on his bicycle by that time.
Oh,
but
shit.
He was bleeding out of his face and everything. I was so
good.
Well, I was walking around for a hillbilly, like a hillbilly for a couple days. Just, like, the entire tooth just gone, man.
Were you pissed?
I wasn't happy about it.
That's like one of your teeth, man. Like, that's one of those things.
That's some important
like,
shit.
And it's not like... And
you
like,
need them to eat.
Like, trying to explain to people, like, oh, you got in a fight downtown and you lost your tooth. Like, no, no. Like, I was standing there and a bum punched me.
After I was trying to help my friend out.
It's a big difference. Like, we were caught. I wasn't even drunk. I was like two, maybe three beers deep, you know? Yeah. Like, and it was just a quiet Tuesday. Quiet.
Yeah, like Nexus Brewery.
Like yeah, Tuesday every
every Thursday at a Dew Cafe, doing it well.
Is that how long have you been going at that now? Every
single Thursday.
Thursday, okay. So you because last time you were here, we were talking about how you were going to start to implement the Thursday thing.
How has the Thursdays worked?
Much better. It's easier for me, at least for sure.
Is there less conflict with other shows or other spots?
Absolutely,
right?
And because there's that one at Launchpad beforehand. At like 5 or something.
Yeah,
so people go to that and then they can stick around and check mine out. And you still get to go home at a decent hour. You know what I mean? 10 o'clock is not really breaking.
And you've
the
already
bank.
Done 2 open mics by that point, right?
Yeah. You get some good time in. And then like this last Thursday was awesome because Medman and Rethman was at 11 right after my show down at the L Race.
Yeah.
So we just walked right on down there and fucking.
How was that? Was that cool?
Raged. Yeah, it was awesome.
Fuck,
they had Be Real with from Cypress Hill with them.
I didn't even hear about that until the night of. And yeah. Like,
they were here
like
6 months ago as well. Fucking killing it, dude.
Would have been fucking killer to see. How long was the show?
They did a solid hour 45.
Okay.
Just because they, you know what I mean, got to be done by like 1:40. They got to be done at like 1:45 or some bullshit, whatever it is for the.
Any broads there? Sausage fest.
Yeah. No. I mean, there was broads, but
they were all
nothing worth like going after.
They have the same. The other day, Royal told me that he's like, yo, I have this girl coming over. She has the body of a pile of laundry.
That's terrible. Oh my god.
So, fucking leave it to Royal to say some shit like that.
And so I was just thinking, did these broads look like a pile of laundry? Is that the kind of broads we're talking about here? I mean, sure, I owned a Volkswagen once. No one's going to steal it, but...
People will still get in there.
I don't...
People will still get in there. No one's going to steal it.
Hey, Alan, you need to get yourself a Volkswagen for a year or two. It's a rite of passage.
Get
Is
a
it?
Passat. Yeah.
A Passat?
TDI.
What?
You'll get there one day.
It's a turbo diesel injection or some bullshit, whatever. That's what the diesel Volkswagens are, TDI.
STD?
STDI.
Where you been for the open mics? Were you at Back Alley on Monday?
No.
No, you weren't.
I started working again. I'm doing marketing and sales again for a healthcare corporation, doing hospice, home health, medical supply, personal care service.
Cool.
And a buddy of mine and I actually, within the last 2 weeks, just got our LLC squared away. We got our S Corp. We fucking put our got our backing from our business partner and started a new company called Enchantment Equipment Leasing.
Okay.
And what I'm doing is power rentals. So you need a big ass generator, I'm the guy that you call.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, it's a pretty good setup.
What is a big ass generator?
What about a power bottom generator?
40 kilowatt, anywhere from 40 kilowatt to 125 kilowatt, right about now.
And what would that power?
Power bottom generator. I just got that. Dude, I'm sorry. You get me start talking about like my work and shit. Yeah. Like the funnies turns off. I'm just like in business mode now. You know.
So wait, how much would one of those like power like a house for a certain amount of time on a certain amount of fuel or like what?
Yeah, that's a giant 100 gallon tank on some of them. Some of them get bigger, but they run on diesel and they'll go for a good minute. You can power an entire house on one of those until the
cows come home.
Yeah, until the diesel runs out.
Oh.
But the pricing on them is different depending on what size you get and if you're running it on regular shift, double shift, triple shift, all that kind of stuff. I got a daily rate, weekly rate, monthly rate.
Yeah. Do you have a lot of people that are asking about the generators for use of a zombie apocalypse?
Oh, God, that would be
probably
nice.
The same people.
Because they'd be renting that on a long-term basis, and that would be really awesome. The more I can rent them out, the better. No, I haven't had that yet. Like I said, we're just getting kicked off. My first actual job, my first client, I'm going to service that person. not the day after tomorrow, but the following Monday is our first job that we got. I haven't even received my equipment yet. I just ordered it all. Fucking... Well, yeah, when you drop a shitload of money on equipment, that's when it becomes real. Like, you can file all this paperwork, but whenever, like, you're just in the hole,
yeah,
you just it just totally in debt, that's whenever, like, it hits you that, oh, man, like...
Fuck, this is... well, so you, that's taking up
taking
a lot of your time.
Of time, yeah.
So what is that, like a day gig, night gig, both?
Both
like long days and shit.
Yeah, well, I'm working my regular job, still working my job, and then before and after that, I'm doing my own private personal shit.
Yeah.
So
you're fucking turds.
Basically, like I'm doing. Oh.
you're doing turds. Your own personal shit. You fucking turds.
Yeah, I'm doing it. I like to
flesh
put
turds
in saran wrap, and then I throw them in the freezer.
Oh yeah,
they. I don't fuck my turds. My turds fuck me.
See, so it's like it's like it's like belong, the zombie fleshlight. It's like necrophiliaism because it's cold.
The old... It's not gay because it's my poop. It came out of my butt.
That's the Alaskan pipeline, right? Is that what it's called? I believe.
No, I call it the Keystone.
Ooh. Keystone.
Keystone pipeline.
Yes, sir, trying to keep it topical here, guys. That's what we do.
It is. It is.
Creepily into the mics because it makes the ladies feel fucking special.
Hey, ladies, I know you want to, you know, get close to what's going on in the action, but there's a problem.
He's got a 7.5-inch dick. And,
you're not incorrect.
He's got to give it back because it's not his, but he's holding on to it for now.
Yeah.
Yeah, what is he doing with Royal's dick?
7.5, that's all for Royal.
I hope it's bigger than that.
Well, you said he was. You assume he was a power bottom. So
yeah, that's why.
What would you need size for?
The reach around.
I mean, you know, they say it's not the size of the boat; it's the motion of the ocean. But big giant cruise liners do way better in a storm than a fucking little dinghy. You know what I'm saying? They got the stabilizers and shit.
Exactly.
Drop anchor.
Plug Ola. Kyle, we've established Edu.
Yeah, I have a Facebook page that I just promote shit on.
Do.
Kyle Merrell Comedy. So
share
if you
want
to look at that. Kyle Merrell Comedy.
Yeah, you should definitely share that on Potential Problems podcast page. Or
no, I was saying he should share us.
What?
Yeah, I'm down. I don't know how to do that. You show me.
All you gotta do is... Like, your account is linked in the initial post. All you have to do is hit share.
Just show me after this.
Every Thursday, folks. What time? 8 o'clock?
It's from 8 to 10, but if you catch me there at 7, man, come have a sandwich with me. They cook some fucking killer food over there. Try the banh mi.
The banh mi?
Uh-huh.
What's that? Just find it.
Yeah, you gotta go.
They cook James Bond.
Alan, you'll be here.
I'll be at Back Alley Monday.
There might be more things in the works.
And where Thursday?
I'll try to
come
make
on, you cook the
girl. I'll try.
There might not be a soul can.
You wanna fucking use an accent with me, eh? I'll use a fucking Australian accent the way you've never fucking heard, you fucking blimey bastard.
Alright, can I give you guys my English accent?
Yeah.
I be from Great Britain down under.
That's Jamaican.
And down under is Australia. That's what makes it such a good British accent.
Thanks for listening, folks. Thank you very much. You guys are awesome. Thanks for coming on, Kyle. Thanks, Alan,
for having me,
your hard work. Thanks, guys.